everybody. Oh, welcome. Before we get started, I was asked specifically to read this. Her Majesty's Right Royal Role Playing Game Expedition or Exploration Society, or RPGES for short, was founded in 1891 by Lord Domwell Zookington III. His vision guides us to this day, to strike out into the untamed wilds of the tabletop, seeking new games and new ways to play, to bring our discoveries and share with the public at large for their general betterment and edification. Thank you to society historian Sir Jordan Caves Calliman Smythe for this write-up. Guys, welcome to
what do we do?
The Royal Role-Playing Game Expedition, where we are playing playing different games all the time. I am the host of this session, Eric Raggart, and we are today running Delta Green. Yay! So I guess we will start out like we start most of these, by going around the table and introducing everybody. So, Mac, why don't you go first?
I'm Mac Bouvet. I'm usually on Phoenix Dawn Command and Misadventures, and I haunt your nightmares probably on a regular basis.
Oh.
Yes, haunt them. It's true.
Oh my god.
Hey, I'm Mace. I run the Lost Brigade every other Wednesday, play that D&D. Tune in this week. It's going to be something special is cooking.
Oh, dang it!
Yeah!
I just ate a goldfish.
I just ate a goldfish.
I'm a Vanna. I forgot to eat today, so my dinner is goldfish and nuts. And this Coke.
But like the ones from the pet store, it's super creepy, guys.
Yeah. I'm Wes.
What? Oh, okay. I see. I'm eating live.
Worth it. Yeah, eating live. Yeah, okay. It's not funny anymore.
They're cheap. They're cheap.
They might be cheaper than the snack goldfish.
They might be.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, 2 week lives.
And that's kind of chewy and crunchy. You get a nice texture combo.
Yeah.
I love small bones.
I think you just have to go with it. I'm Wes Otis. I run Black Bag Vikings, which is on this Friday. So tune into that because it's fun. So there you go.
Yeah, if you like this and you think, hey, well, I want more people going slowly insane, then we do a show where that happens too.
Yes.
Only they got Vikings in that.
Yes, definitely.
So first off, obviously, we have to thank our great Lord and Savior, Domwell Zookington III. We have a photo here of him. Everyone salutes him at the beginning of this show.
I'm Canadian, so I think
because back in the day there wasn't a lot of RPG exploration. You had, you know, the RPG you were raised on by your parents, and nobody knew any better until he came around. So thank you for that. So for this game, we are all playing. These people are all playing Delta Green, and you can actually contribute to the game. Normally, in Saving Throw, we have different things that you can donate towards, like rerolls or adding new bad guys, and it doesn't really work with this system exactly. So what we do is we have a donation tier system, which Dom will throw up in chat and show you what you get. I wrote those up so you can donate towards that, so different things will happen when we reach certain goals, and Dom will tell me, and then those things will happen to the players. They don't know what these things are, but that's kind of the point, isn't it?
I'm sure they're hugs.
Yeah.
It's all right. Most of them are too chicken to ever do anything to us, so we're in the clear, guys.
Don't poke the bear.
I mean, we all know
chat
that
bear.
The chat is full of a bunch of garbage people who are too scared to donate exactly. To get all of these tiers.
Are you the called garbage people guy?
No, that was Sean originally.
You said going that with such conviction. I was like, I've changed my mind.
You defected.
I have a new god now.
Yeah. I mean, they... I've dealt with them long enough to know that they are garbage people and cowards. The lot of them.
Right? See, I've never gotten a single one of them to help me kill a player because they're all too chicken to do so. You hear me?
Yeah. Or chicken. Tracy kills
everyone.
Herself.
Or Tracy kills herself, and I'm like, all right, I literally can't save you from this.
They certainly don't make me try and kill other players at the table ever, ever.
No.
Certainly not every time I play a game.
Yeah, they're too big of cowards.
Sorry, just go back to playing D&D, guys. We're going to play some Delta Green here.
All right, so I think for this session, I'm going to take these off so I can see.
Right now.
Quitter.
Yeah.
Now look who's a coward.
Me, obviously. This session, Delta Green, is a pretty adaptive system. You can set it wherever you want. They have, I think they're even coming out with a book if you want to set it in the 1960s. It has a very rich history that's been around for a while and people creating different scenarios. But for this particular scenario is one I cooked up where all the players are members.
Things are happening.
Thank you to the Bard 1971 for resubscribing.
Woo! That scared me.
Yeah, so he subscribed, and we heard that noise, and then we can read it out, because I took my glasses off and can see the screen now.
My glasses.
Yeah, so for this particular scenario, you were all members of a expedition in Antarctica. You were all part of the Skyweather Foundation, which... is a foundation that funds different scientific endeavors throughout the world. You all have various grants. Some of you, I believe Mac's character is just a general pilot who's been hired for her piloting skills to fly helicopters around and supplies.
Just so we're clear, I'm the engineer, you're the pilot, so we're the only ones getting out of this. Because if you die, we all die.
You have this funny assumption that you're getting out of this with me.
I'm pretty sure I am.
You have this funny assumption that if by the end of this, you'll want to live anymore.
I already don't. Yeah.
So you all, through whatever your schoolwork or you know, fancy letters or you know, letters from the president that recommended you, got a grant from the Skyweather Foundation to a research facility in Antarctica where you're pursuing your various scientific endeavors. And why don't you guys go around and introduce your character, maybe say some stuff about him, make stuff up if you want. It's fine.
Okay.
It's canon.
It's all canon.
It's all canon.
Even if we make it up.
Yeah. Unless I just say it's not. And then.
All right. I'm playing Lao Zhen. He's half Chinese, half American. He's got a Chinese father. Grew up in Southern California. He's got a boyfriend, Keith. What's up, Keith? You know what's up. I'm a biologist, and I'm very excited to be on this expedition. I'm really young, and I'm super eager, and I barely got out of school. So let's do this.
I'm playing Sandra Sandra Jesperson. She is a pilot. She does have a son that she's trying to send to a better school because apparently the one he's at right now is terrible. She would like to learn how to cook. I'm assuming she would like to do that for her son at some point. She has a long distance boyfriend as well, which kind of, when you're a pilot, that's how it goes. That's how it goes.
It's because you're so high in the sky. You live in the same city, but like usually you're
totally.
Several miles above it. Yeah,
totally. Yeah, I just live on a blimp.
Constantly.
I'm a pilot, damn it.
Yeah, I am Jacob Dixon. I am an engineer, a family man with a son and a daughter and a wife, and I'm really far from home. I'm Canadian, and so I'm relatively agreeable.
I think you have like a bonus to sand checks if you're Canadian.
Yeah. Oh, that's fine.
Oh, yeah.
It's all good. Yeah. Oh, geez.
Sorry. My bad.
Oh, yeah.
My bad.
I'm Jackie Stokes. I'm 35 years old and recently divorced. My husband's a good for nothing. And, you know, I'm really focused on proving myself to myself and everybody around me. I just want to finish my dissertation, get tenure, and uncover magical things no one ever else has, and disprove mysticism.
You went into like a Georgia accent there at the end.
I'm not a consistent voice actor, but I'm still a voice actor. And yeah, that's, and I'm really tough, and it comes across like that. So don't mess with me.
Mm-hmm.
Agreed.
Tough. Yeah. All
so
right,
thank you, BSB Care, for the $5 donation. The rest of you cowards who were too cowardly to donate.
Oh my God.
It's up to you.
Oh, Lord.
So you guys have been...
Whoa!
Thank you to...
Keganis,
for the $25 donation.
Uh-oh.
So is that okay. That's the first tier, right?
Yes, first tier is unlocked.
Okay.
How long will it take us to figure out what they're donating for?
Okay, we'll just go around 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh my God.
3, all right,
so. Oh, shit. Oh, geez.
You, oh, you get that if you want.
Ooh. May I read it?
If he lets you read it, it's for him to decide. So thank you, Keeganis, for activating the first tier. That was the tier I hoped would get activated, because that's probably the most fun to play around with, I think, personally. I wrote it, so I'm a little biased in these things, but who knows? So you guys have been at your outpost. It's a fairly smallish outpost. It's not an incredibly large outpost. There's you and maybe a few others at this outpost doing your various scientific endeavors. And it's starting to get to the tail end of the summer season in Antarctica. Antarctica basically has two seasons, summer and winter. Summer is when the sun's out, and winter is when it's night for 6 months, and it's filled with horrible storms. So it's towards this the tail end of the summer season. Most people leave the continent at that point in time. So some of you are probably planning to go home in the next few weeks, or you know, maybe stick it out. But if you did, you would probably go back to McMurdo Station and abandon the outpost you're at. As you were all going about your day, the head of your station, a woman named Anna Fisher, just comes to a few of you and says, "Listen, there's an outpost not too terribly far from us, Outpost 31. It's not one of ours. It's by the Apache Corp, and they sent up a distress signal and then went completely silent, and we don't know what's happening. And normally we'd leave this to the marshals or any number of other people to handle this, but there is a storm coming in the next day or so that is going to cut off travel very badly for any incoming helicopter pilots, and we're basically the closest they can go and render aid. So I need people to basically go there and find out what's going on with this station."
I'll do it.
I volunteer. Okay.
Great.
You're not going anywhere unless I decide, because I don't think any of you are qualified to fly.
Yeah, I think she's right. It's true. That's very
How
true.
Risky is risky?
It's if you get in, taking off now, it'll be fine. And if you get in, if you get out within 16 to 24 hours, it should be fine. You should
That's
easily make it outside.
Of time. We'll be okay.
Yeah, that should be plenty of time to make it outside before the storm makes it really bad to fly in.
You'd all better be ready to go by that time, because I will leave without you.
Okay.
Fair enough.
Sounds good.
Okay. So, Outpost 31, it's not very far from where you guys are. It's maybe a two-hour flight. But you guys are pretty far inland in the continent. You're pretty far out from McMurdo or any of the, which is basically one of the only big stations. And it's the summer, so it's not terrible. It's maybe in the negative 30s at the moment, which is pretty
brisk.
Sweater
weather.
Yeah, it's pretty brisk. It's not bad for Antarctica, but it will get much, much colder as the weeks approach. So all of you volunteer to get into the helicopter. Is there anything you want to like bring or you think you might
tools,
need?
Tools, my tools,
yeah,
that kind of stuff.
Yeah, you can easily bring
first
that.
Aid kit if we have one.
Yeah, yeah. You have a number of medical supplies. Your station has a small medical facility, and you and Anna would tell you that the Outpost 31 is a slightly larger outpost, so they would probably also have medical supplies at their disposal there, too. But anything that is ours is yours to take with you for this.
Emergency flares.
Yep.
C4.
Tommy gun.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know if you would have...
Ooh, Xenar Faith!
Thanks, Xenar Faith.
Yay, Xenar Faith. Thank you for resubscribing. I don't know if we have...
Oh, and C4. Tippy 22.
Oh, and Tippy 22. Thank you for the $5 donation.
Hi, Tippy.
I don't think that they would have... C4 is more of a military-grade explosive. There might be... I mean, you are a geologist, so there would be probably be dynamite. If you needed it, I don't know. I would say that...
I'll take it.
I don't know if you would actually need dynamite. I would need some convincing. Maybe like a...
Do we know she's
especially
bringing dynamite?
Especially if you're going to bring it.
So wait,
let's
review. We have one person who's going to leave us if we don't get back on time, and another person asking for dynamite.
You don't know.
We're
that.
Just going to help these people out. Yeah. I'm just saying.
It's okay. Okay, I got a Galaxy phone recovered.
Also, an old time radio and five batteries and
electric torch.
A magnet.
Okay.
What's my run?
Run. Basically, you can you can run fairly like if we ever get into combat, it's basically you can move about 3 meters free, and then anything more than that is like anything. You can move about 20 meters a turn, basically, if you're, like, really sprinting. But, you know, just a normal human speed.
I appreciate being Canadian that you're using metric system.
Yeah.
All right.
That's what it says in the book.
Yeah,
okay?
I know.
I don't understand what the M is, but that's... I would say that if you wanted to bring dynamite, you would have to try and convince...
Bureaucracy? Would that work?
I would say...
I need it for papers.
I would say, I mean, you have demolition, right? I would say that you could use your demolition as, like, convincing Anna to...
Oh, threaten to explode them.
No, I would say, like, explaining to her why you would need it.
What
like, yeah, you...
No, you never know. If you're going to run into a site that needs a little extra oomph from the excavation,
there could be people, there could be...
People
could be trapped in a moon cave.
Yeah.
We're on the moon, right?
A moon cave?
I'm not convinced I want to let her on my helicopter.
Yeah, just...
You guys don't know. I'm just talking to...
Yeah, if you're just talking to Anna, I would say Anna would eventually probably go, well, I mean, yeah, there could be, like... I know that they have drilling equipment, so there could be a cave collapse or something, so maybe it's possible, like, I could see a situation where maybe it's possible, but please don't hurt anyone.
Last resort. Last resort, as always.
All right.
After 10 hours of bureaucracy, everyone at the other place is already dead, and we failed them horribly.
I've got my dynamite. There's one stick.
But look at all this paperwork I finished.
Yeah.
I mean, that's really the heart of it, is if you got the paperwork, you got the dynamite. That's how it works.
Is that what Delta Green is? We're just filling out paperwork for 3 hours?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Requisition forms.
Did you not? I sent you the free rules explanation. Most of this thing is filling out the proper forms.
I thought it was my tax information.
Yeah.
Oh, I submitted that to the wrong people. Yeah.
I'm also going to call my husband and tell him that I never loved him.
Okay.
Ow. That's one of your bonds, though, right?
Yeah, I don't mean it.
Yeah, okay.
Is that your relationship?
I just wanted to feel extra bad if I die.
Okay. I would say roll human int against my opposed...
to convince him?
Yeah, well, just because he's...
he's dead inside.
Ooh, close, but no cigar.
I would say it's for this, it's an opposed roll. But yeah, he's like, what? Because I rolled real poor. So yeah, it's like... but
goodbye, Reginald.
And you just hear some soft weeping as you hung up.
My name was Frederick.
Yeah. Like.
It's the ultimate burn. What's your name?
So if you're all squared away, I would say that you guys can head out on the chopper. There's obviously a helicopter pad all designated. As you sort of approach, you can see you can clearly land there. If you wanted to land somewhere else, you can, but it's hard to, like, it's not easy to tell how level the ground is in Antarctica, what with all the rock and ice, so you probably want to stick to the helicopter pad.
We do have helicopter pads for a reason.
Yeah, yeah.
Sarah, why wouldn't you use it?
They're a suggestion.
Yeah.
Oh, no, they're not.
He's like, here, I'll make one. Land there. So if you're landing there, you basically, when you guys get out, you see that there's kind of, there's the sort of two main entrances, a side entrance, and then if you wanted to get around in a back entrance as you will. Can, but this is Outpost 31. This is the blueprints you have for it and the facility for your exploration.
Do we see anything on the outside that's out of the ordinary, or does everything look fine?
Everything looks like a pretty standard outpost. There's nobody out and about, but there usually isn't anyone really around.
I'm gonna go investigate the doorway.
All right, that one?
Yeah.
So you get through there, the door is closed, but it's not locked, and as you open it, you see it's sort of a gateway that has just a bunch of, like, coats, and there seem to be a fair number of coats hanging on the rack, like you would see, like, a full staff of people, like, nobody's out and about, apparently,
okay.
So there's seems like enough coats to have enough people there.
Turn around, there's plenty of coats in here. Southside 512, thank you for the follow. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Southside.
We got plenty of coats in here. It doesn't look like anyone's gone.
Okay.
Yeah, a little cold outside to be going out without it.
Plus, you got that dynamite to warm you up.
Dynamite?
What?
I'm ready.
Lit.
It's a real dynamite gal.
All right.
I mean, does it look like, are there lights? Does it seem like electricity is running?
At the moment, it doesn't. I mean, from the outside, you would, like, there are emergency lights on the pad that are probably connected to another system that show you where the pad is, but you don't notice any immediate light. I mean, it is daylight out, but the hallways aren't lit or anything from what his character can see. It doesn't seem. And as you sort of enter in, you do notice it is, I mean, not that it's not as cold as it is outside, but it is colder than it normally should be in here, in that it doesn't seem like the heat is on.
Okay, I relay that information to everyone. There's no power, but it's cold as hell in here.
Well, let's go search the base. I mean, obviously that's probably where they're at.
And maybe find out where the electrical boxes are. Try and
Would
get power
I know
up again.
The layout of this place because of my background of being an engineer?
Yeah, I mean, it's a fairly standard sort of layout, and even and this is not through your company, so it would have different things, but you would be able to see like power lines and stuff that would lead you to where the generator is.
Right.
I'll just tell you, it's that red box there. If you go there, that's basically, from what you can surmise, is what the main generator is.
Right.
Okay. We should probably try and at least restore power to get things started.
All right.
We'll have an easier time searching.
Yeah. Yeah, that should be the first thing we do. So let's just start searching. Let's go on in and find out what's going on.
Do we have flashlights?
Yeah, you can have flashlights.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not too dark because there are windows and it is daylight. Even though it is late in the day, it's still, because it's Antarctica, the sun's still out.
Are we just going to tromp down the hall then?
Sure. I'll take point. I feel invigorated since I know that I have my boyfriend Keith to support me.
Yeah. Ooh. Maybe it's.
We're still going.
Are we gonna
just go through the door?
No.
Why
are we all working? Why are we walking in this way?
Yeah. It's so cold. Yeah. Just want to warm up, guys.
Lions and tigers and bears. Oh my!
So as you get to the generator room, like all of you can see that the generator is not only off. It looks like somebody has done something, not just like turn it off, but has purposefully tried to destroy it. I mean, you would know using your mechanics. It's not dead. You could fix it given, you know, maybe 10-15 minutes, rewire some stuff. But it's like somebody turned it off and then pulled wires out.
Well, do you guys want me to take the time and get it
going? Well, we both have mechanics, so why don't we work on it together?
We can, yeah, totally.
Yeah,
sure.
Two.
And I'm sorry, what was your character's name again?
Jackie.
Me and Jackie can explore the facility, see if we can find anyone.
Don't go too far.
Oh, buddy system?
Buddy system? Should we guard their backs while they're busy working?
Guard against what? There's no
Someone's
one up
obviously
here.
Tampered with this device.
Yeah, there's two of them.
Mm-hmm.
Let's split up, gang.
Oh my God,
yeah,
Fred,
you've been watching a little too much Scooby-Doo.
All right, but we're not going far. Let's just check out this room right down the hall so we can still hear them.
I'm sending.
Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine. So
this is us. Is
this you don't mind splitting up the group.
All right. When you head in there, you notice this room is... Ooh. It's not as well insulated as the other rooms. It's a little colder. And there's a chain link fence that sort of covers part where the green line is. And the inside the chain link fence is filled with straw and various other things. And you notice, like, as you are looking, there's a little bit of movement in the straw.
Oh, shit. You guys have been gone for 2 seconds.
Puppies!
Sean Wiley, what are you doing?
What are you doing?
Yeah, you yelled out puppies.
Oh.
it's funny, because as you yell that, you notice a snout come out. And then a dog,
I fucking told you.
A Siberian
it's
husky.
Yeah, it's
thing,
yeah.
Oh my God.
Coming out of
my character
this pile
doesn't
of
know
hay.
That. Yes.
Oh my God, I love dogs. I rip open the gate.
Can you hear her? I can hear her.
Yeah,
I don't know where she is,
really,
but she actually resonates
really
through the whole place.
Wow. You're greeted by a rather friendly dog, comes right up to you sniffing and looking. It seems like this dog has been alone for a little while. He seems like very excited to see people.
Oh, you poor thing. I pull out a chicken.
A chicken?
A chicken filet. Chicken nuggets. Yeah. What do I have? Real quick. I got
chicken fillet.
Oh, thank you, BSB Care, for the $15. That one's not making noise.
Oh, yeah.
We're just loud.
Yeah.
Maybe I have like some beef jerky
pocket. Yeah, you can have like, or like, food. Like maybe you brought a sandwich. You know, you can have.
Yeah. I give him half my Sando.
Yeah, he's very, Sando. very
calorician.
Very.
Sorry.
He's happy to eat it and gobbles it right up.
I'm gonna name you Caesar.
Caesar.
Short for Little Caesar's per pizza.
I mean, he just sort of waggles his tail and looks at you.
This is the best day of my life. My ex-husband never wanted me to have a dog.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. That's all over now.
I'm going to look around. Is there like a leash or something we could?
Yeah, there's some leashes and some harnesses. It looks like he was part of a group of sled dogs. Some bases carry them because they are fairly reliable from time to time, but not as common. But, you know, they don't require gas and they don't break down, so they're useful. I'd say about this time you guys would probably be able to figure out how to start this generator and get this working.
Should we make some rolls?
No.
Okay. It,
we are not that
croissants,
good.
Croissants?
Because you know.
Well, I have wanted to learn how to cook.
You guys? Because you're not trying to do it like immediately, I don't think he does. Oh, yeah, he does. I would say yeah. Yeah, I don't know if I wrote that down.
I just didn't, yeah.
Yeah.
Are you all texting each other?
Yeah, I would say.
No.
Someone text me.
I would say yes, like something small. Yeah. Okay. I should have written that was one of the things I should have written down. So you guys started up, and because I mean you're both trained mechanics, so it doesn't require a roll, it just requires time because you're not trying to do it like immediately. So you get the power back on, you guys you're petting the dog and you notice the lights start to come on and then you hear the whirling of the heaters starting to kick in and starting to warm up this place. Mm-hmm. It's going to take a little while for it to get comfortable for you to like not be wearing a jacket, but
I'm never taking this off.
Yeah, so it
it's my signature.
It's part of the reason you got divorced.
I care too much about my coat. Yeah.
So you guys, you hear like the whirling, and it's starting to feel nice. You can start to feel the heat, and then you hear something else that sounds like grinding, and then a large crash, and it sounds like it's coming from through the hallway. Through the front door.
It's okay, Caesar.
Through the front door that we came out?
Yeah,
we should probably go catch
him. Yeah, let's go check this out.
Okay.
I'm gonna leash up Caesar and take him with so he's not alone.
Yeah. He'll follow you and even without the leash, but yeah, you can get that.
Okay.
But even with you leash him up.
I don't
just
know
for
him.
Safety. Yeah. he might run off, you don't know. Yeah.
Where did you get a dog?
This is Caesar.
So as you round the corner and you head outside, you see that your helicopter is actually spinning, but you notice the blades are spinning very weirdly, and you notice nobody's in it, but it's spinning and spinning and spinning, and it's trying to take off, but no one's in control. And you even spy that there's some sort of rope holding it down, or maybe a brick like on the pedals, and it starts to lift off and tilt and then just crash on the side, and it is now completely busted.
Is it supposed to do that?
Are you seriously asking me that?
I don't know how to ride helicopters.
You think that's what a helicopter is supposed to do?
Do we have any way to contact?
Did you break off?
I've been a pilot long enough to know how to fly my helicopter.
Someone
has sabotaged it, obviously.
Can we check around to see if we see footprints or anything leading away?
Yeah, you definitely see footprints in the snow. One set of footprints that comes through here and then back in.
Ooh. All right, well, let's go that way because we need to beat someone.
Yeah. We'll let the angry Canadian lead the way. Get him, Wolverine.
There we go.
Snick.
So is he asking how much for that, or?
That's always a bad question.
Dictating. Oh, he's dictating?
Yeah, but.
Listen, if you gotta ask how much, you can afford it. Yeah. Just like our chat.
We don't negotiate with terrorists.
Or prostitutes.
I'm inclined to allow that because, you know, because it's funny.
All
right. So you guys head in there. You notice the hallway is much like the last place. There's a few coats. It's not as big as the main entryway. But yeah, the hallway continues through this way and down here.
What's your chief?
Well, is there any wet footprints from the boots?
Yeah, you can see that there's some wet footprints leading down this way and into this.
Let's sort go of down
is
that way.
Is there anything of a bludgeoning nature, like a pipe or something that's chilling that
or
I
stick
could pick
of dynamite?
Up?
Make a luck roll. Just a 50-50 chance of a D100.
All right.
16. You need one more die.
Oh, wait.
You're halfway there. Still fail, but.
CC4.
Depends on which is which.
Yeah. So 64?
Yeah. Yep.
Could be 46.
Whoa.
Well, I rolled one first, and then the other one was the second number.
So
64.
Okay, I should have said over or under first. That's my mistake. I'm trying to do too many things.
Welcome to the hot seat.
Yeah. I would say just, again, and tell over, under. Do you want it to, like?
Over.
Over, okay.
Sure.
So.
And then you roll the dice.
Yeah.
And then you roll over, you're good to go.
Okay. So, here, I'll roll again.
Oh, crit.
What is it?
Ought 9.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I'm really mad. Somebody destroyed my helicopter.
Should've stopped.
Yeah. you maybe reach for a pipe. And then you just feel, luckily, the heat's only just coming back on, so it's the hot steam pipe is not a hot steam pipe, but you go, that doesn't come off.
Damn it.
All right, so you guys see the this would be easier if I just whisper it. You guys see that as you get here, you notice that there is some sort of blockade. It seems like this is a sort of computer server room and that some of the servers have been tipped over, making entrance a lot harder.
These people really don't want to be saved, obviously.
I think there's something else going on here that has nothing to do with that.
And that you guys don't understand sarcasm, but okay, we'll move on.
Do you understand sarcasm?
Not really. I'm Canadian.
That explains so much.
Anyone in there?
Is the dog, was he picking up on any vibes?
I mean, he's just kind of following you, happily following you.
Okay.
Yeah. So as you call out, you hear the very familiar sound of a shotgun being cocked.
Oh shit!
LOL.
Great.
Is this entrance open?
Which
into
one?
This room?
Yes.
I dive in there.
Yeah. You can head in there. In there, that is actually. Let me look up what that is.
More guys with shotguns.
So no.
Yeah. I'll you go are to the ambushed. Other side of the door.
That like is right actually, there. As you...
Yeah, no, I'm...
That's where the guy's shotgun is.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Like right there on that wall.
As you sort of enter here, you notice this is kind of a lab. Or not kind of, it is a lab.
Yeah. It's part lab.
Yeah.
Part green room.
Part lab, part cop.
Part Havana, can you grab me water? Thank you.
Well, we're all going to be screwed if we don't get transport out of here.
Yeah, we got to get a way to get out.
What's all this then?
All right. Thank you, Gannis, for that. That's not what I was planning, but that's good. You hear, like, as you called out, heard the shotgun, and you hear, go away! Just go away. Just get out. Just go away.
We have nowhere to go. Someone destroyed our only transport out of here.
Oh. Okay. Yes, that did. No, but she can't have it. She'd want it, and I can't let her have it.
Who is her?
Then what is what?
Candace, she's got it. She can't. If she gets out, she would use it, and I can't let her use it. I have to stop it.
Okay, calm down.
I'm gonna use my psychology skill to maybe talk him down a little bit.
Okay.
Sick of Ray.
I'm gonna look for another way into that room.
Oh yeah. 44. And I'm at 60 for that.
Okay, yeah, and that is a critical success because you rolled doubles and under.
Asleep.
Yeah, he's like, it's okay. What are you
is
saying
he right
to
here?
Him? Yeah, he's inside this building, but it's got like
okay. A barrier. I'm just kind of gonna like, basically. And I've got the dog. That's like here. A therapy dog.
Push me into that other room. I'm this looking one? For another way around.
Yeah. That room is
a bomb.
Yeah.
That's the spider room.
Yay! All
the spiders.
Yeah, that is a sort of a map room. You see like various maps and stuff like in a table of like just geographical stuff and just all that kind of information is in there. So what are you saying to him?
I'm like, hey, listen, we can see that you're scared and we're not here to hurt you. We were sent to help and look, Caesar here. He seems to really like you. Do you want to say hi?
Oh. I never really dealt with Derek's dogs before. If the dog liked you, then you're not one of them.
One of what?
Not us, but them. I don't know what happened. It's confusing.
It's okay. It's okay. What's your name?
My name is Owen. I've been alone for a while.
That's obvious.
Hey, now you're in the other room.
Shotgun. I love it.
Well, why don't you put the shotgun down and we'll talk and you can tell us what's been going on.
Oh, I don't remember holding this.
Well, that's terrifying.
Do you remember loading it?
And then immediately unloading it.
Okay. And he sets it down. And he just kind of sits down, sort of like crisscross. Just sits down on the ground.
Can we push past the barrier at all?
Yeah. It's,
and is there a way back around behind him into that room?
Yeah. Yeah, there, you could get around pretty easily through here if you wanted to. Yeah.
The minute he sets the shotgun down, you come through.
No, that's, yes, yeah. Exactly. I'm going for the shotgun. Yeah.
I don't know. He's just kind of mumbling things to himself that are kind of hard to hear unless you get real close.
Okay. Can I get in at the shotgun?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm taking that away from him.
Okay, you can, yeah.
So I guess I'll go inside and... after he calms down a little bit, ask him exactly what happened.
We were digging for it, basically. It's why we were here, and we thought we could get one up on them, and then
okay.
By finding
it. What was it that you were looking for?
The protomolecule.
The protomolecule.
Yeah, I mean, it's why else would we be out here? We thought we found some that they didn't know about.
Who is they?
Do you guys honestly not know?
No.
We got an SOS signal from our base that you guys needed help.
I'm not supposed to say these things, I think. I don't know. It's
Well, you're going to have to tell us something so we can help get off
guys,
this place.
I think he's been under a lot of stress. Maybe we should.
I mean, are you hurt?
He's fine. There's a dog.
Do we have something to do that?
We have a brick.
What the hell?
No, we shouldn't do that. We need him to tell us information.
He's frazzled right now. You think the information we're going to get is any good?
Well, that's why we should make sure he's not
I don't
hurt
think a concussion is going to help
okay.
any.
I want to use my...
Because I have first aid.
I got medicine.
Okay.
Which would probably be more accurate. Medicine or...
Medicine is more of a, like... Yeah, is more like a doctor thing. First aid is like putting a bandage on
a
cut.
Does anybody have a mental disorder okay. that they'd have, like, psychotropic drugs for?
I mean...
Did you bring your weed?
Nope.
They do have a laboratory that you would just
you
in.
It on
they
no,
might
no,
have
no.
stuff in there.
There you
I
go.
Don't know what kind of lab it was, but okay. Yeah, I'll go back to the lab and take a look around, peruse. Yeah.
Go find some Xanax.
Yeah, so that kind of just, you know,
how many,
take the edge off.
How many people, you said that we weren't one of them. How many people are one of them?
I don't, it's just Candace that I know about. She's the only one.
And who is Candace in relation to you?
She
unrelated. entirely.
She she worked here, and then I don't know. She's not the same. I saw it. No one else believed me, but I saw it.
Something happened to her.
She's not Candace anymore. She says she's Candace, and everyone thinks she's Candace, but she's not Candace. That's why I put her in the tool shed.
How many people are in this facility?
I don't.
How many are supposed to be?
There were 12 of us.
Were 12 of us. How many are left now? Just you and Candace?
In the shed, apparently.
I think it's just...
Better than the one.
Just be the two of us, because there's more than they're not them.
Did I find anything, any sedatives or anything in the...
Not in the lab, but this is also a medical, if you spend more time exploring. But in the lab, the lab doesn't have much in the way of drugs. Okay. It's just a bunch of experiments, a cage full of dead mice.
Oh my God.
Where's this tool shed that you put Candace in?
It's on the north side, in the back entrance. It's this.
Oh.
Right there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. And you said that, so what I'm gathering is you found this proto-molecule you were looking for, and it somehow had some bad effect on Candace, and she went insane? Is that right?
She's not Candace anymore.
So she's something
what
else.
What is she?
I don't know. Okay, I'm not the guy that does the things with it.
But how could you tell it wasn't her?
It was her eyes. I could see it. I could see they weren't eyes anymore, or they were, but not people eyes. I don't know.
Was there any kind of helicopter, snowmobile, anything that could transport people away from here?
Yeah. I mean, there's the dog sleds, and in the garage, there's a couple of snow vehicles.
Well, snow sleds, probably not so much, because so far we've only found the one dog.
What?
I hope there's more.
Why did you decide to sabotage the helicopter?
Because Candace, she can't leave. I don't know if she can get out of the tool shed, but she has to... The cold will kill it. That's what... Did you turn the heat back on? I think the cold stops it. I don't...
He's rambling. This is insane. We need to get out of here.
Yes.
Hmm? Yeah. I think he's had there? A break with reality.
It's a pretty well-stocked
we can take
first aid, aid, anything you can... Just about anything you
Let's
can expect to find, including
working.
Sedatives. And also, there is a on the slab here, there is a dead body.
Oh! Folks?
Like in a subtle way?
Do you come
way,
back and
like,
get us?
Oh, no.
Or no, I just kind of like holler down the... kind of lean back. Hey y'all.
All right. Move me.
Hey, y'all. Where
move
you
me we'll along just, down.
That's how you say you all, right?
Mm-hmm. We I'm take, we yeah, you say, can, you know, hey, come with us.
Okay. Yeah, you can follow. He can follow along if you want. It's currently
why'd you leave me back there?
I didn't want to move you unless you said something.
Oh, okay.
The dead body is on a slab, and it's covered but it's not, whatever's covering it is hiding some gruesome stuff.
That's unpleasant.
You know, I'm okay not looking at this.
Yeah, we don't. We get the gist.
Dup.
Who is this?
It's Derek.
What happened to Derek?
He was the first one injured, and they thought it was just a mining accident, but it wasn't a mining accident. That's what we found out.
What kind of accident was it?
I don't want to remember.
I know you don't want to, but it will help us get off this, out of this situation if we know what's going on.
Will it?
Did something crawl out of him?
No.
Oh, okay.
Or into him?
I'm winging it.
I mean, honestly, we can take him with us.
I wasn't there, but it just something, he got hit with something and it almost ripped him in half.
All right. I want to raise the sheet on one side and take a look.
What are you doing?
I'm a doctor. What do you want?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I would say...
Me too.
My job, sir.
I forgot.
I would say, yeah, because you're a doctor, you don't have to make a sand check. But yeah, the body has literally just
like the textbooks.
Cut basically from neck to genitals, like and not just like with a knife or anything, but like torn out, like something not sharp with the force to just tear open a human being.
Cute.
All right, grab him. We find the snowmobiles. He can explain when we get back to base. We don't have a lot of time.
True. Show us where the snowmobiles are.
They're in the garage.
Which is next to the tool shed,
and they
probably
might make some repairing, so we need to
garage
start now.
Is here.
Oh, well, maybe, that's easy enough.
Where's the rest of the people at, though? Where's you going to take this one dude?
What I do you want to do? Do you want to stay out here and potentially freeze with the crazy guy?
Well, we came out here to investigate and see where
I came out here
are.
To fly you out here.
You did.
And I intend to get out of here.
Understood, but you're obviously not flying anywhere.
How about this?
That's why I'm heading for the snowmobiles.
Let's make sure that the snowmobiles are intact and at least secure so that we know if we have to leave. If you want to investigate, we'll talk about
and
it then.
And we need time to repair them if something has happened.
But let's
them.
Just check if they're...
I just want to find the people, that's all.
You
we
have
found
fun
one person and they've been
the
split
then.
In almost two. So that's
why
a little worse.
Why out here? If we're not going to find them, why do
no,
you
No, that's
come?
Why you came out here.
Yeah.
There's at least five more dogs.
Wait, what? Yes, she's right.
That's it.
Okay. First sled team.
I'm heading back towards the shed. Screw these guys.
Yeah, I head with her.
To the
shed, yeah.
The garage.
I just
yeah.
the garage or the shed?
I'm sorry, garage.
Well, your garage.
Yes.
That.
As you can get in there pretty easily, and you do notice that he attempted to sabotage these as well, but again, being mechanics as you are, you can probably spend maybe an hour or so putting back together, maybe salvaging some parts, but...
So, why we do this for the hour... Get over
yes.
here. While we do this for the hour and get these ready to go, why don't you guys take the time to look around for some more people?
Dogs.
And then in an hour, we'll talk once these are ready to go, okay? And we'll keep him here with us just in case.
Do you guys have your walkie-talkies on?
Our
yes.
boxes?
I'm sure we have walkie-talkies,
yeah.
right?
You
yay!
We need to keep in some kind of contact.
We just have cans with really long string. Yeah.
If you do find anyone, be careful about engaging with them. We don't know what's going on here.
Engagement.
I'm 3 9-year-olds.
I'll never get engaged again. Worst time of my life being married.
I'm never going to fly a helicopter again after this.
That'll make your pilot license useless.
That's okay.
There's planes.
That's
Zeppelins.
True. Zeppelins.
Zeppelins never crash.
You live in
no. Over this.
They only catch fire.
That would be your mode of transportation. That would be the one that you would like, a Zeppelin.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Land ho!
Plus, I'm sure my helicopter actually just messed up because somebody didn't put their phone on airplane mode.
Yeah. Sorry.
That's true.
That's a myth.
I don't have a cell phone.
You literally have like one of those box.
I just have like six
things.
Walkie-talkies.
A bandolier of walkie-talkies.
All right, so me and Mace are off.
Yep.
Oh, and what about Homie?
He's going to stay with us.
He's going to stay with you?
Take him
in the corner.
But he might be able to, like, give us info on, like, rooms and stuff. Or, no
or
if you guys
want to
take him, you can.
He might
become a liability. I think he's better off here.
Well, as I've exhibited, I'm the one who's able to talk to him the best and calm him down a little bit.
If you want to sedate him, you can.
I think we should because he's very erratic. He's already tried to tear
I like
up
him.
Maybe he can be your next husband, but I... think for all of our safety.
Yeah.
Should, let him get some rest at the very least.
Sure.
Are we having this conversation in front of him?
Yes.
I mean, I'm right here.
He's not, he's calm, but he's not okay, like mentally at the moment. He's very much like a child and he will just follow wherever you sort of instruct him to go to.
Is there a cot in one of the other rooms we've been in and we can set it up where we're working?
Want to set up somewhere though?
I think
you kind of want to keep an eye on him, right?
But if he's in the same bay that we're in, we'll put him in the corner.
There's not a cot, but there are. I mean, this facility does have bed chambers and stuff like that, and you pretty easily find those because it's fairly standard layout. So you would be able to find where people could sleep. So if you wanted to put him maybe in his quarters, but
I'm not leaving him there. I'm dragging back bedding, and he's going to sleep in the corner where we can keep an eye on him.
Yeah, that is entirely possible. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't want him, like, wandering off and screwing up something else. Because he could be the one killing people. We have no idea.
Exactly.
We have no clue.
Okay, I want to ask for the pills. And then I'm just going to talk to him calmly and lay
him
down.
Oh, you thought it was a pill.
Huh?
You thought it was a pill.
The sedative? Is it a shot?
Yeah.
It's a suppository.
Oh, okay. That's what I was thinking.
and I'm just
take a deep breath.
Give him an enema.
Oh, and I'm just going to give you thoughts. I'm just going to give you this nice shot, and you're going to lay down, you're going to feel good, and you're going to get some rest, okay?
Okay.
Everything's all right.
All right.
And I give him the shot.
Yeah, you
the
just.
The geologist is giving him the shot.
I mean, you.
I'm also a psychologist, asshole.
Yeah, you're right. That helps.
You stick him with the needle, and he almost doesn't even, like, acknowledge that he was stuck and will, like, slowly drift off and take a nap wherever you guys leave him.
I tuck him in.
Yeah.
Just in the forehead.
Nope.
Are we sure we shouldn't also sedate her?
I don't know. She has dynamite.
I just did a nice thing. Why are you trying to sedate me?
Nice glass of milk.
Wait, why?
There's no ketamine in it or nothing.
Not a single one.
All right.
Sorry, I want the person we don't know and is in a horrible state of unwell and unrest want to make sure they feel comfortable and safe. Why does that make me crazy?
Let's get to work.
Fuckers.
All right, so yeah, let's start working, and you guys go and get Scoobied.
Ruh-roh.
Ruh-roh.
We do have a dog with us.
Yeah.
But will he do it for a Scooby snack?
Yeah.
Man, do I find some Scooby snacks?
I mean,
probably back at the kennel.
They're 30% marijuana.
Where do you guys
want to
explore first?
I'd like to check out the map room. If that's okay.
Yeah, it's wild, man.
See if there's anything in there.
You guys would see, what are your biologist, your...
I've got geology, psychology, and chemistry.
You see a lot of this is maps that, I mean, you don't work in this area specifically, but it's pretty standard geological maps, underground caverns and stuff like that, and readouts on various, like, just, the different mineral deposits that are underneath, which is a little... outside of normal, because nobody is allowed to own land or, like, mine land for materials in Antarctica, so the idea that they are actively tracking, like, where there might be oil or where there might be tin or various other metals is a little, but not crazy that they would have this information.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, next room, I guess?
Sure. Server room or the lab? I'm gonna try and write the servers.
Yeah, so
set them back up.
Yeah, you can write them up, and most of them have come back online just because they weren't unplugged or anything, but that one can be plugged back in fairly easily, and now it's just where they store a lot of the information here.
All right, I'm going to just kind of pour through it. If you want to take Scooby and check out one of the next rooms over here.
Yeah, I don't think we should split up.
Well, you got a dog, so... Not really.
Okay, I guess I'm worried about you being by yourself.
Nothing ever happens to the guy who just stays where he is.
The doctor's always the most secure.
Right.
I'm going to stay here till you're done.
Okay.
So you're just kind of perusing the servers?
I also have computer science, too, if there's a role for this or anything.
Okay, yeah, I would say, like, you could each, like, pop up on a console and sort of search. And then maybe you do find, I mean, it's not uncommon, but there are things that are they're slightly encrypted, which is not uncommon, especially this is a private organization that would want to hide some of their stuff. They are sort of a private foundation. Skyweather does the same sort of thing. But if you wanted to maybe break this encryption, that would require some rolling.
Yeah, I'll go for it. Oh, dang it, 54. And I'm at 50%.
Okay. So you're not able to crack it just yet. And do you want to also
attempt to break it? Yeah. 10.
Mm. Okay. You search around a lot, and one thing sticks out at you is there is an email from the head of the research facility, whose name is, it's on there, but Jerome Tate is the head of Outpost 31, and there's a lot of just regular correspondence, but this one is an email that was encrypted, so it sticks out to you.
Well, what's it say?
Hold on, I'm a slow reader.
You could read it out loud.
I could.
So the guy's asleep, correct? And
yeah.
We're working on this thing.
Mm-hmm.
And how long have they been gone at this point?
Only a couple of minutes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so it hasn't been long. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, apparently this place possibly has a basement.
Ooh, is that all it said?
Pretty
much. Reading that for like 100 years.
This guy was a long love letter.
What?
It was a love letter.
Let me read it.
I don't want you to read
Move.
It.
Move.
It's in Dutch.
You are right, David. It's here. There's a massive deposit of proto-matter under the ice. It was easy enough to find once we knew what to look for. I don't know how our allies could have missed such an obvious spot. We really struck gold on this one. I know you always advise caution, but I'm moving forward with drilling tomorrow. We've got the full setup and running in the basement. As for our friends from out of town, if they didn't know about it, then we can take it without raising alarms. If they do know about it, we can play dumb. Better to ask forgiveness than permission. Jerome Tate. These guys seem like maybe they weren't on the up and up.
I'm sorry, what?
You know, they were up to something. No good. Shenanigans.
Maybe. Doubtful, but maybe. And if they're here, they have to have had rights to be here, so.
Yeah, but you and I both know drilling's not allowed in Antarctica.
Yeah, be careful with the
drilling. Two of us like drilling, could be excavating.
The two of you, I would like just to make an alertness check.
We got the dog, too.
Yeah.
Nope. No es bueno. Thanks.
What is it, boy? 37. Fail.
Okay.
Blissfully unaware.
Just read me.
Elephant going down this. You guys.
What is that? Oh, it's a marching band.
Yeah, marching band. No clue.
That's how he fixes things.
Mm-hmm. So there. That's about the most pertinent information you're able to gather that you share with her when she jabs at you for it.
Come on. Fork it over.
Yeah. And everything else seems like fairly normal stuff.
Hmm.
But you do notice that, like, the encryption has sort of locked down a lot more of the files at this point, and you think you would need a lot more time to open anything up here.
I power them down.
Yeah.
Should we push them over again?
No. What's wrong with you?
Dang it.
We'll be fine in the cold.
All right. Do you want to go down the hall?
Sure.
Like, he's asleep. You should check to see if he has any more shotgun shells on him.
That's not a bad idea.
Okay, that room is a greenhouse, and it seems like all the plants have pretty much died from the cold. Like, whatever was keeping them alive, the heat, it is off now, and they are most certainly dead. Mm-hmm. Some of them look like they almost froze in place, which is a little weird that they would survive long enough to keep their color and you know, but they are all pretty clearly dead from what you can see just offhand.
I look at any of the specimen names, or is it just like standard flowers and stuff?
They seem like fairly standard flowers to you. Flowers and various things, just
run-of-the-mill flowers here.
It's not entirely clear if these were experimental plants or if they were literally just trying to grow carrots and stuff to offset, the stuff they had to ship in.
But that's all that's in there?
Yeah, it's a green room, or a greenhouse.
Hmm. It's one of those places you wonder why they have a little text thing in the video game. You're like, this has nothing.
Yeah.
Green room.
It's the room inside of Resident Evil that has like a full 3-page Umbrella Corp file that doesn't say anything.
Right, exactly.
Oh, Umbrella. They're thorough.
All right, well, looks like there's something going on in here. Moving on.
Starting to get frustrated, yeah.
Does the dog smell anything? Anything weird in there?
Not in there.
In here, maybe?
In there, that is the... What is that?
I'm going to start calling out.
Caesar, what do you smell, boy?
I think that's this... You know, this area is sort of bathrooms and showers and stuff like that.
Oh, he smells a dookie.
Yeah. I mean... Maybe he urinates in his shower.
I don't think it's okay.
But nothing. He doesn't.
Urinates in the shower.
Yeah, I mean he's got to go. He's got to go.
Sanitary.
Yeah.
Mm. Okay. Good boy. Yeah.
Does the guy who we sedated have any more shotgun shells on him?
He's got, really in his jacket pocket, he's got about a handful of them, maybe like six more shells.
Oh, damn.
And all right, just I'm going to take those and go ahead and pocket them.
Yeah.
And while he's really heavily sedated, just see if he has anything else on him that might be helpful, like a note or anything.
A cool tattoo.
He doesn't have any
Does he have any injuries at all? Or
he looks, I mean, he looks a little like he hasn't eaten in a while, and he's been kind of staying awake through either force of will or chemical means, but he doesn't look all that, he doesn't look injured. He didn't, like, nothing has happened to him.
Okay.
He just lost his mind.
Right. Why are we taking the long way around? We know there's somebody in the shed. Why didn't we just go there?
Well, hold on.
I thought,
in video games, there's always something
hiding
in the toilet.
That's why we're working on the snowmobiles.
We don't know how to get, there's no doors out here.
Yeah, there's
so maybe if we keep going down here, we can take find a back exit out of this place.
Sounds good.
So let's just, while we're going through these rooms, take stock.
More dukes?
Yeah, it's like bathroom, showers, and I mean,
I'm gonna do the showers.
This is like crew quarters, so like the various people.
I'm looking in all the toilets. Yeah. I'm flipping back showers like this.
Something in the mirror, and then it's gone.
Yeah. Is it me?
No.
Oh.
Exactly.
Caesar.
It's Caesar.
You goofball. Is there anything?
Nothing that kind stands out. If you want to take time to look, there's a little marijuana in one of the bunks. That, you know.
A shower bunk?
No, in a crew quarter, sort of like a person's.
Is this crew quarter?
This is all kind of like.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Shower, bunk.
Yeah, sort of. It's not. This part's not as to scale as I would
I'm
like.
I'm taking
it.
That.
No, it's to scale. Yeah.
I'm taking that weed.
Yeah.
Is it for smoking?
Yeah, I mean, it's up to you what you do with it. I mean,
you could bake brownies with it.
I've seen Reefer Madness. That's something I've known from the 1930s.
So there's various crew quarters, some TVs, you know, beds, and just what normal stuff you would expect from this kind of, you know, not, I mean, a little bit Spartan, but actually their rooms do seem a little nicer than the kinds you guys have been staying in. But they are a private corporation.
Oh. What's the big idea? Aren't these places nicer than ours?
Maybe they have better funding.
We should go private. Next mission, me and you.
Private.
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 Oh, here it is, the back entrance.
Mm-hmm. Yarp.
You first.
Okay. I head on out and then I go over to the shack.
Mm-hmm.
Is it intact?
It is intact. It looks like it might be fairly well insulated, but the door is sort of chained shut. It's there's no like lock, but it was wrapped in chain, and then like a bar was stuck in the doorway so whatever was inside couldn't get out.
Okay, well, I'm gonna call into it. Hello?
Hello? Oh, you hear someone like calling out, but their voice is rather weak, like they've been screaming for a very
Jesus.
Long time.
I immediately began unchaining the door.
All right. As you get in there, you
exactly
open it up.
What you should do.
And there's a woman in there.
Do you want to play? We're going to go home and play it safe.
There's a woman inside there who she looks like she's.
Do you know it's through that door?
She's in
plot.
She's kind of a little heavier set. She's in her 40s, and she's wrapped up in a couple of different coats. She has like a small heater in there, but it's a lot colder in this shed than it was inside the building.
Christ, I peel off my jacket and wrap her in it.
Yeah, she is actively shivering, but says thank you.
Candace?
Yes, I'm Candace. Thank you so much.
I knew he was a madman.
He shoved me in here and he wouldn't let me out, and I don't know what's going on.
Never mind, she sounds a lot like him, so.
Candace, it's okay. You know, we got your SOS signal. We're here to help you.
Oh, thank you. I didn't send it, but somebody else probably did.
Are you an evil witch?
No.
Okay, just checking.
The question is that.
Well, that's what his description. It sounded like maybe she was
possessed,
or an evil witch or something.
Are you a sorceress?
Are you a good witch or a bad witch?
I'm a biochemist.
A witch.
Good witch.
Druid. Oh, no. You're a druid then. Okay.
I'm gonna start leading her back to the facility.
I'm gonna check out what's in the shed.
Dukes.
What's Caesar think? Oh, he loves Dukes. Thank you.
Actually, Caesar kind of is a little upset by Candace. He doesn't want to be around her. He's sort of like pulling away as she's getting closer. He doesn't
Caesar, what's wrong? I don't know about this. I don't know about this. Me, is that what it is?
Yeah, but you can call me Zen.
Oh, I won't though.
But you can. It's never gonna work if I give myself a nickname.
Lee, I don't know. This is
such
Caesar.
A dweeby doctor. Call me my nickname, please.
Super cool. Caesar doesn't seem to like her. You know, this is some classic case of the body snatchers or something.
What if that guy
was being kind of truthful? I mean, he was crazy, but like, what if he?
Candace, I'll see you inside. I'm going to have to word with my colleague.
You're going to let him go away?
She just hobbles inside. She's like, thank you.
Are you a doctor or what?
Listen, dogs know these things.
Listen, I know I'm only 23, but use your head.
Oh, I've got several.
What?
I start reaching in.
What?
Oh, I don't know. She didn't. I put it on her character. She has a third head.
Yeah,
she has three complete heads.
My head, Caesar's head, and my second head.
Yeah,
I'm gonna start absorbing them.
Was that not clear when I thought
my three heads?
Haven't you ever watched a movie, Lee? Jeez.
Lee, what? No. Yes, I watched movies.
Yeah, you know, like Invasion of the Body. You never know.
But that's not what happened in Invasion of the Body Snatchers.
Dogs, he hasn't
Our psychologist
reacted like
has
that.
Had a break with right. reality.
He hasn't reacted that to the three people he's seen.
Yeah, exactly.
Let's
keep an eye on her.
I agree. Let's not call her a witch. Let's not say she's a body snatcher.
Too late.
Let's get you some warm milk.
Too late. I don't know. I don't mind.
Okay.
I'm going to look in the shed.
Yeah, it seems like a fairly standard tool shed, but... It looks like Candace took a lot of the tools off and was actively smacking at the door. It's very well beaten, but the tool shed is held strong, so there wasn't anything she could actually get the doors open with, but she certainly tried.
Are there any tools maybe I could take that would be beneficial?
Get a big old bar?
A saw.
Yeah, they would have various, like a handsaw and stuff like that, and maybe a chainsaw, if you wanted to carry that.
No,
Or like a baseball bat where the nails
She's
have just
got
been hammered right through.
Dynamite in one hand and the chainsaw in the other.
I'm like, Hulk, too.
I've been through a divorce, damn it.
There's an ancient Chinese halibut in there.
Halibut. That would be better.
It just smells terrible.
It grants one wish.
I'm gonna take
if you
a
let
chainsaw,
me live, I'll give you. Yeah.
Not to like, so I can drop it in the garage, not to like. Yeah, carry around
it's,
with me or
it's kind of like there's a small like it's not a very huge it's the kind that you guys would know it's for like cutting through pieces of ice which
oh, okay,
yeah
okay.
So if you need to like cool, take yeah. ice samples so it's
core
it's,
samples all yeah. that stuff
well the core samples is a different tool but you would find that in there too like a drill that you could do for core samples or
that'd
for
be
detonation.
A great way to kill someone just shove a core sample thing through their
I feel like I've seen that in a movie
yeah. I have not
who's the crazy one now you're talking about murder.
I hold not, my I shotgun don't know. Closer.
Grip it tight. To
this will be useful in case we need to get through any barred passageways or.
Apparently not. It didn't even open that door.
Oh, maybe there's no gas in it.
Is it electric or gas?
I don't know.
It's gas, and there are no gas.
It's solar,
in it.
Which makes it really efficient.
It's gas in
it's good for like 11 months.
Yeah, exactly. Rest of the time, you're fucked.
Okay, let's take it to the garage and get some gas in it.
Great idea.
All right, you guys sort of reconvene.
Where's Candace at? Did she run off? Or?
Got on her broom and rode away.
Yeah, she
yeah.
She's kind of like.
I told you she was a witch.
In the hallway, she's just kind of like shivering because it's significantly warmer in the building now than it is in there, than it was in the tool shed for her. So she's enjoying it. It's still not, you notice it. It's still not that warm. It's actually, having come from the tool shed to the outside to back inside, you actually notice it actually hasn't gotten any warmer.
God damn it.
What the hell? All right. Let's pile up our people, I guess.
What? Pile them up?
Yeah, let's all get together.
Oh, yeah, let's go back.
Give this one a little sleepy dose.
Do a little confab. Will we hear them coming down the hallway?
Traveling music.
All right, I'm gonna spin around with the shotgun spaced at the door because I hear people coming down the hallway.
Okay. Don't shoot!
Ah, cheese.
You've been gone forever.
Look what I got!
I didn't give that to her. She found it.
Don't think for a second you're getting any of this gasoline for that.
Listen, what is your problem?
Well, we do
you
have to
You showed up
it
with
home.
A chainsaw,
yeah.
And we need all of the gas that we have to get out of here.
Okay, but we have to...
He woke up?
And
no, this no. is Candace.
Oh, sorry.
And who is this?
This is Candace.
Who are you?
She's a witch.
I work here. I'm not a witch.
Caesar doesn't like you.
I went to UCLA. I'm a biochemist. Okay. I have a
if she had,
a witch,
she's right. If she had gone to Berkeley, she might have been a witch. But
you
want to
see not nothing?
Yeah. Wait. Is this Owen? What?
He's taking a nap. It's okay.
He's insane.
We need to keep
That's
them away
why
from
he's
each
taking
other.
A nap.
Somebody keep her away from him right now. This is a bad idea.
He hit me in the head and locked me in the tool shed.
Did you just give her a shot?
Give her a shot too.
Okay, I would say you have to. You're gonna have to roll for that. I'm gonna say grapple. So we'll say
55.
Yeah. Okay. I don't know what Candace is not very. Actually, no. I have Candace's stats.
Okay, cool. Of course. That terrifies me if he's got stats for Candace.
So you're gonna try and give her a shot.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Let's contest a roll for this.
Okay, well, I got 55.
All right. That's what you rolled, and that's under?
I'm looking for my grapple. I'm not seeing it at all.
It might not be on there. We'll say...
Do you want to use dexterity?
Dexterity or strength, whichever one you
or
think.
Or stealth?
Okay, yeah, would it be the unarmed skill
actually,
on the back?
Well, because I'm not unarmed.
Yeah.
Oh, syringe. Yeah.
Yeah.
I got a 65 for my dex.
Okay. Contested roll, two.
So I'm under, and I could crit.
Oh, and she rolled a 93. So, yeah, you stab her and then get her, and she goes, ow, what the? What are you?
Take that, witch.
Why are you doing
and I
that?
I use sweet talker. Shh, it's okay.
And then
it's all right.
As you grab.
Whoa, creepy.
As you're like going, shh, she's like, stop it. And then she goes to swing at you. And actually pushes you away with a lot more force than you thought that
Whoa.
She could possibly have.
Witch!
Farm girls.
Whoa!
She's like, Whoa. What are you doing?
Not at you, obviously.
Well, I know, but not at the Candace.
What is wrong with you people?
Like, she's a person, come on, what's wrong with you all?
Yeah, she's frozen. Did you see what she did to you?
Yes.
Yeah, you struck her with a sedative.
When some people have a lot of adrenaline, they can get one good burst out.
She's seething now. Why would you? And she's getting angrier and angrier, and she's not going down. And then
I shoot her.
What?
I shoot her.
You have a gun?
Roll of course I do, yes.
I would
of
say,
course you do.
I run.
What?
He's firing.
I just shoot her.
Hold on. Okay. Roll for it first.
Wait, why are you shooting her?
Why do you have a gun?
He pocketed it.
64. I don't know what my score is.
Unarmed?
It's going to be on the back, right, for shooting?
Well, I don't have a shooting on this because of the...
I would say, like, 60 would be pretty standard. So,
okay.
So you fire...
you have firearms, dude. Bottom.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but his would be slightly higher than what I gave him.
Okay.
So...
Like
are you a secret agent?
So,
witch!
Witch. I'm a secret agent, witch.
I would have given you 60 for that.
Okay. So I sort of failed.
Yeah, so you fire at her, and then she freaks out, and then all of you notice that her body seems
Don't
to
freeze
be
up, shoot!
Twitching, and...
And shoot!
And like...
Shoot her!
Shoot her!
And you notice like her arms are stretching longer
what else
than
do you
they're
need
supposed to.
Shoot!
He's giving descriptions! And
don't let him finish!
Okay, right in the face then!
Different parts of her are shifting around in a way that aren't natural, so everyone... No. Right off the bat, shoot. Make a sanity roll. You're watching somebody do something that they're...
Actually, I saw this coming.
Yeah,
all right, you gotta separate your character knowledge from player knowledge.
I said it in my voice, that was my character
It's story. Still, you may have seen it coming, but it's still the most disturbing thing you've ever seen in your life.
Alright.
I don't know, I've been married.
Second most
disturbing thing I've ever seen. So because I'm afraid of this roll, I'll let you guys go first.
We got there.
Alright.
Go ahead.
Go for it.
Sanity rolls.
Ooh, nice!
You have seen this before.
Yes, this is nothing.
Stupid witch spells.
Go to couples therapy.
68.
That'd be a failure for you.
Oops.
Okay.
was a personal failure.
68. Yep, I failed too.
13.
Okay, everyone that passes, roll a d6 and lose that much sand. Everyone who failed, roll a d20.
Oh, oh Christ.
Yeah, you're watching somebody, you watch as Candace turns into a monster that you, like, she begins sprouting tentacles and eyes begin to appear on parts that aren't supposed to have eyes.
12.
Oh, Jesus.
I'm almost at breaking point.
Yeah, so any of you that got over five, got five or over, enter immediately into fight or flight, which you can lean into your willpower if you want to not
fight.
Yeah.
Flights.
Okay. I have a shotgun. I'm going to shoot her in the face.
So everybody else is freaking out, and I'm just like, I told you.
Yeah.
Caesar, I told them. Yeah. They didn't listen.
You sure did.
Witches. Which, Caesar? What?
Yep. What's everyone saying now? 41.
45.
46, Dom.
Can I shoot her?
I would say, I guess all of you fight or flight people can if you're gonna fight.
An order of dex or what?
Yeah. I'm gonna fight.
And I have firearms, so.
Yeah, so so you will roll based on the firearms.
50, and my firearms is 50.
Okay, then that hits, and then I believe shotgun, if I have it correctly on here somewhere.
Don't ever let the description finish. Kill it, kill it.
Yeah.
Shotgun. How can you say that?
Easy.
He's a keeper.
Yeah, shotgun.
I know, that's why you should.
It was
shotgun
happen anyway.
Is, you're at close range, so that's 2d10 for you.
Okay.
Yeah.
And all right, so I'm gonna fire as well.
Yeah.
I got an
68,
I guess, yeah.
Yeah.
So I miss again.
Yeah, you miss again.
So you need me to roll 2d10?
Yeah, 2d10.
So that's 2.
Ugh, 5.
5? Okay.
Scree
dice. That's good.
I was startled.
All right.
Whoa!
Okay, now
it's startling.
Now
it
we
is.
Get to actual
is
combat.
Yes.
And the way we do initiative in this game
I'm okay.
is we go in order of dex. So who's got the highest dex?
I got
dex?
13.
15.
15, okay. 15 is for
I have 13 as well.
Okay.
I'm very dexterous.
You are, you're nimble.
Dexterous.
All right.
I mean, you should be, you're a pilot.
Yeah.
And a cat.
And a cat.
What is the, are the snow boom
wheels
ready to go?
That's news to me.
I would say they're pretty much, you just got to gas them up and go if you wanted to.
Or we could gas up the chainsaw!
We are not using gas on the chainsaw.
Just a little bit.
No.
I'm not going to listen.
No, none of it.
I'm gassing up the chainsaw. Just
no, you're not. No.
Why?
You guys are fighting this thing, so.
Look.
It's not my turn. We'll see what happens.
Okay, so I would say that the fight or flight kind of did your, would, I mean, you, do you did you have to do fight or flight?
Yes.
Okay, what are you going to do?
Flight.
Okay, so you're gonna try and run away?
Peace out deeper into the facility.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Bye.
These guys got guns, and you got a chainsaw, and this chick's turning into a tentacle
thing?
Yeah,
what do you have, syringes?
I got
that
syringes.
Great.
Yeah, right?
So, I would say that was your guys' turn. What would you like to do?
I'm gonna try and dump some gas into the chainsaw.
All right, that would basically take your turn, but yeah, that would be...
Does she splash anything on herself?
But I'm, like, totally calm. I'm like,
so just
want
to, like... gun butt right in the face, like, stop!
Yeah.
We'll put it, all the stuff I don't use back.
All right, and then as
you're doing this, trying without a funnel, them. Trying to get gas care. Into the...
I always splash. Carry a funnel with me, I'm a extra. Geologist.
Okay.
Okay.
That makes complete sense.
And a psychologist and a chemist.
So, as you clearly just blast Candace with the shotgun, and you see, like, the pellets enter her, and it looks like it should hurt her, but it doesn't, like... do as much as, because she's not a human, it turns out.
Oh,
she's
really? Really? Oh my God, really?
Yeah. Yeah.
So am I standing next to her as she's filling up the gas tank with the...
Yeah, I would say,
are
like...
Are we standing, like, in a row?
I would say, yeah, you're kind of standing in kind of a row, and, like, Candace is... Like, Candace was kind of the last one in, and then all the gunfire started. So,
And I wonder how this would have gone if you hadn't have done that. Yeah. Like, well, how long would it would have taken?
She would have taken us out one by one.
It's possible.
Some alien shit.
So, since...
We wouldn't have known who was who.
I would say since you fired a shotgun at very close range, she's gonna just try and swing at you.
Of course
with,
she is.
With one of her very long, noodly arms.
Can I?
Spaghetti damage.
And she's definitely going to hit. And then do basically punch you for, we'll call that.
100 points.
For
splat.
We'll go down. We'll round down. It's never. Just two damage as she just clocks you with like this heavy hit.
Oh shit!
I'm down to 10.
She's an avatar of the flying spaghetti monster.
Yeah.
That's fun.
Okay.
Did you read my write-up before?
I did. I'm a big fan. I've been following you for a while.
Thank you. Thank you.
My mom is genuinely a big fan of the flying spaghetti monster.
Okay, so Mac, you're up. You just got punched.
You bitch!
Ooh, yeah.
I'm gonna shoot her again.
All right, cock and fire.
Do you have to call body parts? Is that a
you
thing?
Can call shots?
Ooh, yeah!
Four. Nice going.
As it, what you can do is you can one of your actions can be aim, which will give you a plus 20 on your next attack, or you can call shot, which basically I aim for the kneecap, or I shoot over cover, which would give you a negative on your roll, but would hit that thing.
I'm okay, just okay. Going but, to fire right into yeah. Her stupid face.
And that was a hit?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that'd be another 2d10.
See, what are you guys worried about? I knew Chat wasn't going to do anything to us.
15, okay.
Or have they? What?
I don't know. What's I that? Feel like it. Maybe you're a witch.
Maybe. It's possible.
He does have witch tendencies, mm-hmm. Like floating in water.
You're a witch. Like a duck.
If you weigh as much as a duck, you're a witch.
Very
a witch.
Small rocks.
A witch. That is the best one.
So, very small rocks. So you actually Brit. Blast the arm that punched you off of her, and it kind of like, and like is moving a little bit of its own accord.
This is very Res 7.
Yeah.
Right? Shh, I want to play it. I don't want to know anything.
Spoiler alert, something like
I
this.
I started watching your stream and I'm like, nope, I'm not doing this.
I've never tried to sleep again.
A lot of people have had that thought.
It's actually based entirely on Resident Evil Code Veronica. The second half of that game is in Antarctica. No, not true. So, Wes.
Yeah, I was racking my brain. I was like, no, it's not.
Yeah.
All right, so she is. She has the gas can or no? She has,
I took a turn to fill up
she basically took a turn to like fill up her.
Okay.
But there's more. There's it. Other gas cans if you want.
Okay,
the gas
I grab one of the gas cans and I start filling up one of the.
Yeah. Okay.
The snowmobiles.
All right.
The snowmobiles.
Dim snowmobiles.
We're gonna get out of here.
Let's get ready to hit the road.
Yeah.
All right. What are you doing?
You guys
where are you
get.
At? Yeah, well, I'm backing up towards.
Okay.
The
you can move if you're
snowmobile.
Basically, because you started here, and then the last turn you got a move, and you get about, I mean, you could do about, if you're like fucking sprinting it, I would say that this would be like, you start here on this turn, so if you want to keep moving.
Fuck this shit.
I'm gonna tell Caesar to go with him. Caesar, go with him.
Caesar just kind of looks at you.
Listen, this isn't dandy. I don't have to
Caesar,
you know.
You're such a crowd.
Exactly.
You know. So I'm going to be the one to survive. Watch.
By running into the snow.
Yeah.
Yes. Don't let them in. Don't let them see. No? No? Okay, we're not doing that?
No, thank you. I'm just going to go ahead and mark off all of my sanity points for that.
Just from hearing that, a couple bars of that song.
Yes.
Please eat all these. I'm eating
eat them
all
nuts.
Of them.
Thank you. So, you're just running off into the snow. What are you gonna do? Yeah,
I'm gonna rev it up and slice at this beautiful woman.
All right.
Beautiful creature.
What did Mac do to you?
Oh no, that's nice. It's nice and mean. I'm confused. I don't know how to feel.
So you got a chainsaw and you're running at her. I'm gonna say that is melee. Yeah, melee weapon. Base is 30, unless you've got more.
She specializes in chainsaw
that would be on my list.
Mm-hmm.
See, if you took ice sculpting as your craft, boom.
Oh, wood carving, too.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
It's
yeah.
A swan!
Like the guys at Knott's Berry Farm doing bears and stuff.
Those are awesome. Anything. Enhance it. My strength doesn't have a modifier on that or anything.
Okay. No.
No.
I can push it into her real hard. 25!
25, okay. Yeah, she, you run at, you just scream and run at her and just plunge it into her. I would say give me a D10.
That's it?
I mean, it's a small chainsaw.
wiggle it around some. Oh, here we go.
It's not quite the force of a shotgun close range.
For some reason, it's for hedges. I mean,
dang it.
It's a hedge saw.
There's no reason. Sort of the stuff in the greenhouse.
All right. Three. Okay. As soon as I find my pen.
I poked her.
Didn't you hang it up? Nope. You did not.
Nope. There it is.
Found it.
All right. So three damage.
So there's no rerolls in this, right? Or
I mean,
well,
no.
Only if they right. There's no rerolls.
Well, no, I didn't know. I mean,
is
it allowed?
No, I didn't. I was mostly the tier stuff.
Okay.
Good.
Yeah.
How many tiers are there?
There are three tiers. We've hit two of them.
Damn.
Let's see. We hit two of them.
Yeah.
Not gonna hit the third. Not gonna hit the third.
We won't. We won't. Thanks. Because they're too afraid to see what happens
Lame.
When the third one hits.
Lame.
All right. So you did. You rammed her with a chainsaw. We're back at the top. Mac, what are you gonna do? You're gonna.
Did you get enough gasoline into it?
I guess I would.
It would take. Yeah, it would take. Because it turned. It's fairly like.
It's like a second.
Yeah. So you would probably need a.
I need a little bit longer. Just keep.
You better not leave me behind.
I'm not going to.
All right.
Oh, wait, Candace hasn't gone. So, you ran.
I'm sorry.
You're not.
Yeah.
Okay.
Not sorry.
Yeah, and all of you dudes. And I just basically made her go last. But you rammed her with the chainsaw, and they're like.
Is it in her?
Yeah, it's in her as you're like. And Candace.
And I'm sure that's not. Gross at all.
Candace.
There's probably no blood, nothing.
I bet her blood's purple or something stupid.
It's actually not bleeding, which is the
most
unnerving part. And then she, with her one arm that she has left and sort of a vestigial thing that's starting to appear, actually grabs around you and grapples you, and then you can contest this.
I'm okay.
Thanks. So that's.
You guys are dicks.
Why, you're getting eaten, we get away.
She grabs onto you. If you.
You wanted to go to the shed. You wanted to do this, so.
Yeah,
I didn't want to go in the shed. He did.
If you want, you can try and contest this, but
contest
that would,
it.
Yeah, you could dodge it, but it would take up your basically it would take up your move for your next turn, like dodging out.
Don't
I
get
mean,
grabbed.
I don't think I would let it happen.
Yeah.
So,
dodge roll.
It would be a dodge roll.
I would say dexterity or strength, whichever one you want to do.
Yeah, my dex is higher. Shit, dick. yeah, I feel.
All right. She actually grabs onto you and, like, wraps around you. And it's kind of disturbing because parts of her that aren't actually, like she had one arm when she grabbed you. But you feel more, you feel several, what could be arms grabbing onto you and nice pulling you actually inside of her.
God damn it.
So do we, obviously we're filling, we're gonna have to help her out because she's gotten.
But I've got the chainsaw and it's on and it's like in front of me. So
she
would just
use gasoline for her chainsaw.
Yeah.
I don't feel obligated to help her.
God, your like belief in humans is so easily swayed. I took a little bit of your gasoline. Like
did I have any belief to begin with?
I wish I was dead. Like, what
no,
the hell?
I told you guys what the rules were when we, before we left.
One on the bus.
I'm leaving.
When we leave, you're left behind.
Is the now that's the garage door, correct?
Yeah.
And we were told that
look,
he.
My top motivation. Get home safe. If
she doesn't do well in cold.
That's what Owen says.
Right, but so far Owen's been the one that's been right. So when it's my turn, I'll run over and I'll hit the garage door to open up the garage and let in the air.
It's the. Yeah.
Or is it a chain?
It has a chain, but the electricity is on now. So yeah, you can hit it.
We're gonna have to drive out anyway, so the door's got to be open.
All right.
Do they? I've seen enough cartoons. No, it's my work.
What did you pick to? What did you roll? And what were you trying to get under?
I rolled a 73. I was trying to get under a 65.
I would say you passed then, because you have the chainsaw. If you had the chainsaw, it's a lot easier to
like.
Well,
she's like pulling me into her, so she's just pulling the chainsaw into.
Yeah.
Her.
So
but also you into the chainsaw.
Yeah, that's probably true.
Yeah. So I would say it's a little easier for you to get out. So you would. Yeah, I would say you could fight your way out of that while holding an active chainsaw.
You totally are doing like the sculpture thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I really. I changed my thing to explosives. Though,
so we'll break on that. You didn't quite get pulled in. She tried. She clearly did try to like yank you in. Side of her though.
Gross.
Gooey. Mm-hmm.
So, all right, Mac, it is your turn.
Okay, I'm gonna try. I'm gonna try and shoot her again, and maybe not hit her. But I'm gonna, as I do it, I'm going to step back towards the snowmobile because I want to get the fuck out of here.
I would say if you're firing, because her character is right there, so you would have to do sort of a called shot with a negative 20 to it to like not hit her.
You could aim.
Yeah, or you could aim, which would you wouldn't be able to fire this round, but the next round you would be able to.
It's probably like negate that called shot thing. So.
See, how much do I care about other people living?
Roll a die. Even you do, odd you don't. That's what I always do in life.
You're inherently evil.
Let's see what my alignment is. Oh, it says here, dick.
All right, I'm just going to fire.
All right, fire away.
Yep.
And what are you trying to hit under?
How are you going to damage the monster?
Oh.
Well.
Right now.
What'd you roll?
95.
95, okay.
What's like the point of shooting at me?
I would say, how far away did you jump away from them?
I'm always moving it's back towards the
yeah, still
snowmobile.
Pretty close. So 2d10. Roll the 2d10 damage. And then we'll decide. And then you, I would say.
Wait, though, that was a failure. You want me to roll the damage?
And then I would say you kind of. We'll just call this. You fire real wide and don't hit. We'll just say that.
Okay.
Yeah. What a sweet GM.
Yeah.
Nicer than me.
Mm-hmm. All right.
We have three bloodthirsty GMs here. Takes it easy.
Listen, I'm just trying to make this last.
This probably went a lot quicker than you thought it would.
Yeah, it's fine. You can never tell if people are like, I'm going to go to the objective, or I'm going to check everything. You can never tell if you're playing with completionists, or I got
to
just
I'm moving
get
a lot
to
closer to that snowmobile now.
All right, so you're spending your turn basically, you got the gas can.
Gas in, now I'm getting the garage door up.
All right. I figure, I've got, like, 1 foot of the snowmobile.
And then you are still running off into the snow?
How much further do I have to run to fill my fight or flight?
I mean, it was basically just the turn you had to.
Oh, okay.
The rest you just did for fun.
All right, then I'll just out there. Guys! Folks!
If you wanted to, to not have continued to run, I could...
I'll stay where I stopped, where I am. Yeah. This way.
Idiot.
So you're outside?
I'm gonna survive. Yeah, I'm outside. I'm just calling in to everyone. You okay?
And you call, you okay? And you just hear,
call it out here!
Oh god, duck!
They're probably fine.
Yeah. All right, Candace is gonna...
Oh, here they come. He's hungry for blood.
Oh, thank you, Zen Our Faith, for $10.
And Razlak.
Oh, and Razlak for $10. Where's that put us? How close is that? Is that... Put it
nowhere near where it needs to be. They're too sad.
Yeah, I figured it's probably a little ways away.
That starts the shut up, mace, fun.
Okay.
Oh, good. Just good. Another 80 more to go.
Okay, so.
Oh, you're cheap.
You, let's see, Havana, it's Europe now. What are you going to do?
Oh, I thought you were just saying, we're now in Europe.
Okay. You wake up in Europe.
What a delight. Europe is inside this large woman.
She's actually a portal. To Europe.
That's amazing.
She was Europe the whole time. Twist!
Wonderful game.
I'm just gonna...
It's a metaphor for how the EU is just taking over everything.
Yeah. What is the kind of range
Brexit.
on the...
It's pretty close range. It's the blade's only about that long, so it's pretty close.
I'm just gonna go for it. I'm just gonna try and... I'm gonna try and, cut her...
appendages?
Head off?
There you go.
Okay. Yeah, if you're gonna just try and... All right.
53. Fail?
Okay.
So, melee, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So you, come at her, and you start, you do cut a little, but you notice, it's very superficial and not doing much, and you're not sure if her head... is actually a vital organ at this point.
Dang it. My video game logic only goes so far.
Heads are always the weak spot. Mm-hmm.
So is anything like pulsing red or like flashing on her body?
You notice that the parts of her that she's regrowing, or the empty spaces that are being filled that are exposed from like shotgun shells or your chainsaw, are actually a very deep like black ichor.
Yeah. Goo monster.
Yeah, and as you like, you take a step back and like swing at her head, and she like misses, like she like moves her head away, so it dodges away. And you notice like the cut she had in her stomach actually has teeth now. It's just like
Is the garage door open?
Yeah, the garage door is mostly open. Yeah, yeah.
All right, let's go.
Yes.
Thank you, Pope, for
Your Majesty.
Yeah, yeah. Your Holiness.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Holiness.
Let's get this right.
What do you want?
So, what do you think I got this off the problem?
This mouth is actually going to go for you now.
Son of a bitch!
Yeah. So we will call this.
I'm going to hold this. Maybe it'll just bite my chainsaw.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, that'll
turn it sideways.
I would say,
not like that. That's what's wrong.
It goes for you. You can try and dodge out of the way.
I love you, Amanda. You're
46.
Magical.
46.
Stay where you're at. We'll pick you up.
Thank you. See?
Ooh,
no, we're going that way.
No damage.
The teeth sort of like grab at you. You're able to like pull away, but you do feel a scraping. You only take one die damage.
It energizes me.
Yeah, you take
bloodlust.
You just get scraped along the arms as like you pull away just in time to not have your arms bitten off by this thing.
Oh fuck! Okay, cool.
Yeah.
How much damage?
One damage.
Just one.
Yeah, because that was a real bad roll.
Yay! I'm at 11 HP down.
You got a lot more hit points than I do.
Yeah.
I'm a woman.
All the women have more HP than men.
That makes sense.
It's a statement, guys.
We have babies.
Yeah.
They rip us in half.
Not all of us have them, because ew.
I have six. They're all just like me. It's terrifying.
Okay. Mac, you're up.
When I get the fuck out of here. For many reasons.
All right.
So I'm getting on the snowmobile.
Yeah, we start this. We just drive off.
All right, you're gonna start driving. You're not gonna wait for anybody.
No.
All right.
Wow.
I would. Okay.
I become best friends with her.
Let's go and destroy everyone.
All right, you guys.
You don't have to outrun the monster.
You just have to outrun the rest of the people in your party.
You guys start driving, and I would say you can make it like the initial like out of the garage and just like out here pretty easily. You know, it's not a very fast vehicle, but at the moment, there's nothing impeding your driving.
Do we see our doctor friend?
Yeah, you see him just kind of standing out there.
He's extra points if you hit him.
No. Let's get him.
Some results.
Which one of you is driving?
I believe you were.
I think you are because I'm on the back with the shotgun probably.
I'm driving then.
Because I'm going to go ahead and face backwards.
Okay, that makes sense.
And now the chase level begins.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So slow-mo. You two are driving. You see them emerging from a snowmobile that's quickly accelerating.
Hey, wait for me!
How big is the snowmobile?
Can it fit enough?
Fit like the four of you pretty easily.
Okay. So we're good then. We got room for a picnic basket.
We have plenty of room now for the three of us.
It's just starting its roll, so it wouldn't be too difficult for you to hop on if you wanted to.
Really? Thank you, James V, 1971.
Oh, woo-hoo! Thank you,
James V.
You getting close?
Getting Mason to shut up.
Well, we've gotten close, guys. I would say you could probably hop on without too much difficulty, hop onto this vehicle. So, Havana, you are now alone with this weird, creepy monster.
Dynamite time!
All
right. Can I take out a stick of dynamite and light it and then toss it into the mouth?
Yeah.
One cigar she's always had lit in the corner of her mouth.
It's dynamite time, bitches.
Yeah, I would say it wouldn't be that hard, and it's dynamite, so you don't have to, like, roll for it.
I'm going to try to roll away or something.
Yeah, but, like, lighting it and then running away, you can maybe get 3 meters. So you'd still be, I would say you'd have to do kind of a dodge roll to, like, get behind something to not blow yourself up.
Yeah, totally. I'm into that. I'm also thinking the mouth chomps on it is why I feel better about it, but... 82. Weird how hard I failed that. I explode.
Okay. So you light it and then you go,
this was a bad idea.
And then you like,
I regret everything.
You try and you dive behind something, but it's very flimsy.
What is it?
It's
the dog.
No.
No! I told Caesar to go away. No one loves you. Poof. No one loves you, you bad, bad boy.
Caesar ran away as soon as
you killed the dog.
Caesar didn't hang out. Like, he ran away as soon as you guys
noticed
the fight started. So he was out of there. But I would say, what are we going to call
how much damage does dynamite do?
Well,
it's inside of all of it.
The thing about, the thing about certain weapons like dynamite and grenades and like assault rifles is that they don't do damage. They have a lethality rating where you have to roll and get under the lethality rating. If you do, then you take damage. If you don't, then you're just dead. Anyone within the radius.
It just splats you.
Yeah. So that's how that whole thing works out. So I'm going to say...
But it's like in her.
Yeah. But it's still...
It's going to be all over you.
Yeah.
I just want to be splashed with her goo. I don't want to die.
Well, you shouldn't have done my thing.
Try not to.
Yeah.
Phrasing.
I can't not think.
Yeah, it's really...
All right, so I know I got some lethality ratings on here written down.
Thank God you didn't get C4.
Yeah. Crazy, right? I would say lethality.
It's like a little stick of dynamite.
It's like a little bit of dynamite, small. Guys.
Yeah, I mean, we'll say 50-50.
Just a little.
We'll say 50-50 on this. So roll.
What am I trying to do?
You're trying
to energize.
You're trying
guys.
To get under 50.
Okay.
Now who's the witch? You're energizing your rotten dice.
13!
Wow.
Okay, yeah. So you only take some of the damage. And we'll call this a D10. You take 7 damage.
Oh.
You bitches left me.
I'm at 4, Don.
Yeah, so that throws you for a loop. That certainly pops your ears. Yeah, you get thrown around, very well concussed. You were definitely permanently injured in some way. You are not going to walk away from this perfectly fine. You're going to have some serious medical bills in the future and probably a lot of rehabilitation.
Perfect. Good. Mm-hmm. Is my light gone? Yeah. Is it gone?
I mean, it's still there.
Well, you figure you've got 12 points and you took 7, so that's probably a good chunk of your body.
Owen was in there with you guys, right?
Oh, yeah. God, yes. Yeah. We totally just left him.
Owen's dead.
Oh,
that was a wonderful nap. Oh, God!
Mercy kill.
I'm going to have you roll...
I forgot about him.
I'm going to have you roll sanity real quick.
Because I killed the guy?
Yeah, because you just murdered somebody, so...
And she liked it.
36.
Out of... What your total sanity is?
46.
Okay, yeah, so...
This is fine. Fuck it.
You guys been married?
it was an accident. Like, you know it was an accident.
Who the hell were you married to? That was that bad.
You only
don't want to know.
So Russell.
Yeah. I mean, it was an accident, so you're only going to take... So you're able to, like, really think about it and go, it's like, I mean, it's what I had to do. You're not happy about it? You know, you don't
I
wish...
I feel good that I thought about it at all with my mangled legs.
Yeah.
Like, I'm a good person.
Yeah. Yeah. Very good person. So, Owen
She's
said...
Like, Candace... With, like, what's left of her shoulder.
I'm just a torso.
Candace is all over the place.
She gooed it.
Yeah, she's gooed. It's not really in a great state, but there is sort of a key on the ground.
I crawl over to it.
Okay. I would say that, like, you could probably walk with, like, without too much, like, first aid
I'm
stuff.
I'm really tough.
Yeah, you're tough.
Do you?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, you could tough it out and force yourself.
It's amazing what having adrenaline psychosis makes able to make it, like, you're half.
Welcome! I got something. I'm not sharing.
Okay.
Did she make it through that?
Yeah. I don't know. Keep driving.
You have a walkie-talkie.
Hey, guys. I finished her.
It's a trick.
Shut up, Dr. Stupid.
I won't tell if you won't, and I'm just going to, like, let the walkie-talkie go into the snow.
Real talk?
What?
How much gas we have to getting back to the lab? Could we do it?
Do we need
I'm
to
going
go back
to try.
Here? No, not to this one, back to the...
No.
We don't?
We're not wasting any more gas. She already wasted on her chainsaw. That was her choice.
No but do we have enough to go...
I just want to wait for
gas to get all the way back? Or
to the other outpost.
So we're
know.
Doing
Do
a
Do you want to go back there?
You're driving.
I'm driving, so this is a luck roll to see if we have enough gas to get home.
Okay.
This Otherwise, is your life right here. We'll see what happens.
And that might be preferable at this point.
Or, you know.
What am I rolling for, 50?
Yeah, 50.
I'm gonna use one of you like a tauntaun. Above or
below. Below, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Below, but do you want me to re-roll?
What did you get?
I got a 24, but let me re-roll.
I'll accept that. That's fine. So yeah, you figure clever driving and like not like taking it easy, you could probably make it most of the way there, if not all the way there, within like hiking distance.
Hiking.
Yeah. Oh, hiking. Okay.
Yeah. So
within the time frame of not freezing to death.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm seriously one of you. Tauntaun time if we don't get back.
All right, we'll use her as a tauntaun. It's weird.
That would be really.
I grip my shotgun even tighter.
Shh.
Just injecting everybody.
But with a gun.
Why do you have all these syringes?
I don't know. There's like
he's just got like 30 of them.
I made a bad move here. All right.
So you want to drive away?
Yeah.
Okay. And everyone is happy with that driving away.
Yep.
Okay. All right. You guys
assume she's dead.
Or she
I
will
said
be.
On the walkie-talkie, you heard I'm not dead.
I didn't hear anything.
It's really loud with this motor
it's
and the
very
snow
loud.
Crunching.
Yeah.
We don't hear much.
I mean, the Tom.
Why are you guys such assholes?
Whipping around.
Well, you've probably
my character
been
has goals, okay, and they don't involve dying back at that base.
All right.
You weren't exactly a person when you were alive.
You called everybody a witch. There, yeah.
I
said
didn't.
It.
I called someone who turned out to be an evil creature a witch.
But you called him a witch, too.
You called
everybody.
Yeah,
you were doing some sneaky shit, too.
I was just trying to protect everyone.
Whatever.
I hate all of you.
Syringe.
Gun bite.
All right, I'll leave you guys in your car until the cowardly chat decides to donate some more, maybe.
Oh, know. Shit.
But
there's an avalanche pushes us all the way back.
But you are now you're in the base. It's thank you.
Whoa.
Uh-oh. Ryslak.
It is finished.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
So as you guys
it is done.
Of course, we're in the slowest snowmobile
Let's
ever.
Take it back.
As you guys are driving away, you do hear in the distance a helicopter coming, and it's very clearly coming towards your direction, because what else would it be coming from? And you see a helicopter, like a sort of Black Hawk helicopter, heading towards you. And at first, it's like it's seeing the base, but then it starts coming around towards you guys.
Okay, so we swing around towards the base then, mm-hmm. and try to get close. They're gonna shoot at us or something.
Do we have a flare gun? Did I keep
What's your
it
idea?
With me?
We should shoot at the dog that's running around and yell at them in Swedish.
Yes, let's do that.
The dog went this way, asshole.
I'm assuming it's not gonna just stay there, it's gonna keep running.
All right, so I go back towards the building, like if I'd swing back around this way, I guess.
We came back to save you, Jackie.
Do we have-
We were kidding.
Flare guns?
Sorry.
I mean, there would be like emergency flares if you wanted to use them.
I'm gonna fire a flare off.
All right. You see
at
your
the helicopter.
Yeah, directly the helicopter. No.
Let's do this.
No, because I could fly that if we could get him to land.
So you see her go into like the emergency thing and pull out the flare and fire it into the sky.
Why? Okay.
And then, unless you're trying to stop her.
I would say, I think they know we're here. They're following us, and I that looks more like a military helicopter. They could be dangerous.
They're going to be dangerous to us no matter what we do.
Okay.
At least it shows we're in some kind of distress. Maybe they will come and at least check things out. Or do you think they're just going to kill us from the air? Either way, we're in trouble.
I think they might try to just kill us.
Great.
That's my theory. I just go close to the building, and if you want to fire, we can fire and see what they do. But if they've got a gun on that helicopter, we're hosed no matter what.
I mean, it's not a movie,
yeah,
guys.
Yeah, I know. Oh, no, it's not a movie. We just had someone turn into something and try to eat someone else.
By the way, where's Jackie?
She couldn't keep up, and she took an arrow in the knee.
And
she
got married, oh.
Yeah, she took an arrow in the knee, so we had to leave her.
Yeah, she fell in love with Owen and wanted to stay there.
That's wonderful. No, really, where's she at?
She was around here.
Well, part of her's there. The leg is on the other side.
Both my legs.
I thought one left.
No.
No, she's still alive.
Peg?
She's a little banged up.
And a hero.
Yeah. So you guys are like having this debate while driving back and seeing the helicopter.
Yeah, we're going to go like, I guess, over here to where this entrance is would be. We have to run in so that if they're firing at us.
Yeah, it'll take you a moment to get over over there. But while they're doing that, what would you have been doing? You got a little time before they make
me?
It back.
Me? Yeah. Sulking? I don't know. Can I at all like patch myself up?
Yeah, you can like do some minor first aid to keep yourself kind of going.
Get a cutting knife.
Just like stop the bleeding. Yeah. I mean, at this point, I'm capable of a lot of things.
Yeah, you're tough. It says so on your sheet.
Yeah,
you're
I'll a circle it.
It's all sharpening the blade. Yeah.
So you. You
spears.
You're getting Rambo on you, bitches.
I'm gonna kill all you.
Yeah,
fuckers.
I am.
You pat yourself up. You took like a shotgun shell, poured the contents in, and lit it on fire to close the wounds. Like you're doing all the really awesome Rambo shit.
Do I gain back any HP or I just stabilize?
You just kind of like stabilize.
Okay.
Yeah. If you wanted to like gain back XP, that would take a lot longer than what you got. But you're not. You're okay for now.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So what do you want to do while they drive back?
Set up a series of mines.
Oh, I thought that would take take a minute.
They've been kind of driving for a little while.
Well, I guess the key, I'll pick that up and examine it. Is there anything I would kind of notice about it? Or
it's a key. It goes to something, and you're not sure exactly what. These places don't tend to have a lot of locked doors, so. Like,
I'm wondering if the information we found on the server is relevant to that. So maybe I'll try and find the door to the basement and see if maybe the key fits in there.
The basement is the stairs with the thing pointing downwards. Okay. And right about the time you sort of make it, because you're a little slower now, is when they start to get there. And I'd say that you guys could be in the hallway, like coming around.
Right.
Well, we haven't seen what the helicopter has done yet.
It's touching down. It can't touch down at the helicopter pad because of the crashed helicopter there.
So I figured it.
It's touching down a little further away, but you do see people coming out. And they
how
do,
many?
There are four people coming out of the helicopter.
And are they dressed armed? Like?
They seem to be dressed somewhat, like they certainly have they have they don't have any like they're not carrying assault rifles or something. They seem fairly like you've seen like sort of security forces before. Maybe, you know, and stuff like that. So they don't seem like...
And they're over here.
Yeah, they're a little further...
But they're not, like, coming out, like, heavily armed and... Like,
no, they don't have, like, you know, heavily armed stuff. But you do just see some men in coats popping out of this.
We have a decision. We stay hidden. We let them go in. We take their helicopter and we leave.
That
plan.
Or
we try to talk to them. I think number one is the way to go.
That plan.
So you guys are going to hide out and wait for them?
We're going to wait till they go into the building, and then we're going to take their helicopter.
Okay.
You don't think they're going to post somebody at the helicopter?
We'll shoot them.
We do have a gun.
Yes. We have two guns.
We have two guns.
Okay. Yeah, which, why did you have a gun?
I'll explain. Let's do this first, and then we'll do exposition later.
So, who or what they are?
No.
No, we just don't care?
We don't care at this point.
So you're going to just wait there outside?
Yeah, we're gonna hide right here, wait for them to go inside.
Okay. And you're going to head down to the basement?
Hopefully, if she's still alive, she'll be loud enough and they'll draw
her. There'll be no doubt of her being loud enough.
So we're not using her as a distraction.
Yeah. So you guys...
Until she transforms and kills them all.
Right. She's
then
infected at this point.
Fine.
Yeah, she got this.
Yeah, you guys...
She took a face full of that witch.
You guys sort of, like, hide out and wait for these guys to pass, hopefully. And you head down the stairs, and you do notice there is a heavy lock on the door that would fit this key, if you wanted to open it. Yeah.
I want that helicopter.
All right. You open it, and it goes down into a sort of basement, which is it's kind of deep down, and it looks like it was a natural sort of cave structure that they dug out a little bit, but it was mostly naturally there. And there is in the center, there is sort of a drilling apparatus that looked like it was for drilling into the rock and ice. And all around you are the dismembered pieces of bodies. So I'm going to need you to make a sanity roll.
Perfect.
Cherry on this crap Sunday.
11.
71.
Oh, 71. I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's gonna be a fail.
Fail.
So I'm gonna say that's gonna be what is that? Which one of these? A D4. So,
wow.
Yeah. Well, because that's helplessness. a pit of corpses, essentially.
Do you roll that, or it's just
you
four?
Roll, you roll a d4.
Oh, I roll it.
You roll a d4 and take
D4's
that.
Oh, I am a d4.
Yeah, and then you can...
two.
And then you can, if... How close are you to breaking point?
I'm okay right now.
Okay. Then you are very weirded out by all the dead and dismembered bodies in this structure.
Just weirded out.
I'm going to lock the door behind me.
Ew.
And, like, ew. Leave?
No.
Oh, stay down there?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, you could probably do that, yeah.
And then I guess look around, see if there's, I see the drill and the bodies, if there's anything that stands out.
I would say...
Not the bodies, that doesn't stand out at
yeah,
all.
Yeah, the bodies are disgusting and it's hard to sort of look at them. And you're like looking and it's just like, I don't want to look. And so you're like shielding your eyes a little bit. And you notice that the ceiling is moving a little bit.
Uh-oh.
And then you notice that it's not moving a little bit, the whole ceiling is moving, and it's not the ceiling. It's, you remember immediately what Candace looked like when she was changing, but bigger and larger, and it has, it doesn't have a shape that's easy to tell, and it has a lot of mouths and a lot of teeth and a lot of tentacles, but it's just sort of like hanging out up there, and you're definitely going to have to make a sanity roll for that.
Fuck, okay.
They can shove Nigger off.
Yeah.
Nine!
I'm like, this is normal.
Stack it on.
All right, so that's a... What
whatever,
is
I cauterized killed a guy today.
My wounds. I'm fine.
Let's see, what was...
I killed a guy.
So you killed a guy with a chainsaw.
You passed, so it's just a d6.
you should add, okay. Next to tough, you should put badass. It's underneath your paper right there on your left.
Oh,
there.
Thanks.
Six.
Oh. Right. Yeah, I'm under now.
Yeah, you're definitely at a breaking point, and that would be fight or flight. You can use willpower to sort of power through this if you wanted to.
Willpower point. So I would need to roll under a 10?
You'd roll a d4, and then whatever you get, you would lose that less of sanity and lose that many willpower points.
Oh, I see.
So like if you rolled a 3, you would lose 3 willpower, but then you would only lose 3 sanity instead of 6. And you would lose 3 from one of your bonds.
I think maybe I'll just run away.
Okay, yeah, so you run, but the door is locked. So you paw at the door for a second. It takes you a hot second to realize that what's going on, and then you unlock it and flee up the stairs, screaming.
Screaming, perfect.
So you guys do hear a lot of screaming.
Okay, can I make a run for the helicopter?
I would say at this point, yeah, you guys can. I would have you roll, do we have... Is in here? No, it's not a stat anymore. Cool.
Because they're not at the helicopter anymore. They went
no,
inside.
No, they started heading towards the front main entrance.
All right. Yeah.
So as long as we know that they're inside, we run.
Yeah. So you guys see them start heading inside, and you guys just fucking book it?
Yeah, yep. I'm heading for that helicopter.
All right, you guys head. It'll take you a hot second to get there. But you, as you're screaming, notice 4 men sort of walking down the hallway. And you just kind of run into them if you're going that direction.
Okay.
So we're booking it.
Yeah, I run you guys, I don't even care. I'm getting that helicopter started.
So you run like smack into them, and they're like, "Ma'am, are you okay?
Like, what is, I'm gonna hop like right in."
Chainsaw.
Am I covered in like caffeine?
I mean, yeah, you've got a lot of goo on you and a lot of burn scars and some blood. Yeah, you look real worse for the wear. Quite a sight.
There's something living down there.
Okay.
It's giant and evil.
Okay, ma'am. We just need you to calm down. Okay. Just come with us. Okay, come with us, and they're gonna try and lead you someplace.
Cool, yeah.
Okay.
Less scary than what's in the basement.
Okay, and you guys are making it to helicopter?
Like, I'm going to, like, practically leap into the helicopter and just start flipping everything on it ready to go.
Is there anyone in there?
There is a one pilot, and he's just, like, he sees you guys running up, but and as he sees it, you see him fumble for something, and he does pull out a pistol.
I'm going to butt him in the face with my gun.
Okay. That's going to be a melee roll versus his... He's not going to do so hot. Yeah.
Okay. Ooh, thanks for the follow, Randoza777.
Random user, 777.
77?
Versus your melee?
I don't know what my melee is.
It's probably like down there.
melee weapon is 30 base unless you've got extra.
Yeah, it is 30.
Okay.
Nope. F.
Yeah, so you fight and he grabs the, or he like knocks the gun away and stuff. So let's see, what are their dexterities? So if you want to fight him, he's got a 14 dex.
I got 15 dex.
Okay.
Can I talk to him?
Yeah, sure.
I got sweet talk. Sweet talker.
Okay. You have to talk to him right after she turned to hit him in the face.
Yeah. Oh, well, sorry. We've just been through some stuff. Who are you? Hit him now.
So are you trying to... he's like, we were sent here to help. What? Who are you?
What organization are you from?
What's that matter right now?
We have to get out of here.
Okay.
There's monsters and things.
Are you Apache Corps?
Yeah. No, we were sent here.
By who?
But we got the distress signal.
We did too. And there's things in there. We gotta go now.
It's a trap.
A trap?
For you. Sorry.
No, I'm kidding. It's,
no.
Yes.
They got us out here too. We had, we found somebody who was, we don't have time. We gotta leave now.
I start like,
do you have men in there?
With the controls trying to get it ready to go.
He's like gonna fight you, and it's like,
damn it!
And he gets on the radio. He's like, I got three other survivors out here.
Damn it!
It's okay.
And then you hear like, I got three other survivors on a thing. So two of the guys is peel off and head out while this guy is taking you to the medical facility here.
Perfect.
Yeah. So he sits you down, and he's like, okay, I'm going to give you something to calm you down, okay?
Oh,
wow, we
no,
know how
no,
this goes.
No, no, this is all seems very familiar.
Like a bullet to the face.
So do they come out?
Yeah, you'll see the, like, two men coming out. They're like, oh, whoa, 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 hey, we are all here to help. What is the problem, people?
Did you find somebody in there?
Yes.
Is she still alive?
Yes.
Warn your men.
She's infected. You can't. You got to get her away.
She's infected with what? She's.
Get
we
her.
Have to get
your
out
men
of
away.
Here.
Get your men away. It's dangerous. Trust us, please. If she's been infected, she's dangerous.
Okay, I'm gonna have you roll a human int on these guys.
All right. Do, 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 do. I feel happy. It says 10. Is it gonna be higher?
I'll give you like a 30, maybe.
Oh, thanks.
So you can do it.
Generous. A 98 doesn't do it.
Yeah, you don't notice anything out of the ordinary. And they're like, okay. We will pull our men out.
So don't let her, don't touch her. She's infected.
I promise you won't. Can you all just calm down? Please, just sit down for a moment, okay?
I don't feel like sitting, but why don't you go get your men?
Okay. Guys, we're gonna have to, I mean, definitely... Blue Fly protocol on this one.
Ooh. Does that sound familiar to any of us?
Yeah, I mean, you, yeah.
Okay. I sneak out one of my syringes, and I...
Why do you have so many?
Yeah. Hmm? Her.
What? Okay.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Okay,
no.
You're gonna... I would say you would have to... I guess opposing role, Dex versus... Dex?
Do you want to do by degrees of success or roll under?
Yeah, degrees of success, I think.
Okay.
What's that mean?
So that means that you roll your dice, mm-hmm. and say you get like a 45, you'd have 2 degrees of success, because that's 10 sets below it.
Okay.
Same thing for me. Oh, shit!
Not one.
Wonk, wonk.
Nope. Right. So I lunge at her with a syringe.
You see him lunge at you with a syringe.
Shotgun shoot butt him. To the face.
Okay. Melee and then.
Yep.
When I see this, I start shooting as soon as I can.
You start shooting?
Yes, of course.
Hold on, wait.
Probably you.
You know what? I'm gonna shoot him.
Okay,
that's fair.
That actually is a lot. That works a lot better. I'm gonna shoot him.
In the middle of the plane.
I don't care. Damn it.
Is that a 91?
No. 64.
Okay.
All right, you fire, and it just goes wildly as he sort of fires at. And then, I guess, you're both dex 13. The three men that are with you are dex 14, so they get to act next.
Okay.
So they are, the two guys out there, they're outside, will pull out, what do they have? They will pull out pistols and open fire.
Jesus, I give out my call sign or response code.
You will get a chance to, okay. But they're slightly more dexterous. Let's see, that's What is their firearm is somewhere in here, and it's probably less than I just rolled. Yeah. So that's one miss. One solid hit. Okay. So one will, I guess the two of you, you have a gun and then you have a gun. So we'll just D4 this. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's a 2. So one of them fires at Mac and does. You get shot for 3 damage.
Yikes.
As a pistol round just comes at you. Oh no, it's D10 plus 2, so that's 5 damage.
Ouch.
Ouch. You still standing?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Probably.
Yeah.
Alright, okay. So these two.
I've only allowed 9, 5. So.
Me too.
Yeah, so they open fire, so now you guys can go.
Alright, so you tried to.
Okay. Surrender, yeah.
Yeah.
Not trying to kill her, just put her to sleep.
Not okay.
Well, so. Since you're the closest, I'm going to shoot at him.
Okay.
Am I, or is the pilot?
Yeah, because I'm going to go after the pilot.
Pilot's
I want
to take cockpit.
Over.
I don't want to hit
the
controls.
Yeah, there's the pilot, and there's the two guys that are kind of, they're a little further
and
away
from they pulled out their guns as well?
Yeah.
All right, I'll start with them, because you've only got syringes. And I'll try to hit the one closest to me.
All right.
Ugh. I've been rolling,
should
like,
take out the guys that are in the helicopter with us.
Well, I don't want to hit. There's only one guy in the helicopter, though, right?
Well, there's the pilot and him.
Oh, is he in the yeah, I didn't think he had gotten in there.
I'm in there with you guys.
Yeah.
Okay, I thought we were still outside the helicopter. Okay, then I'll shoot him.
Okay,
that's fair.
It's a 40, so.
Yeah, and that's a hit for you.
Yeah.
So that would be a D10 plus 2, I think, for a pistol.
Yeah. Can I spend my round to, or my turn to dodge?
Yeah, you can dodge.
Okay.
Oh, so 4 points.
Assuming you hit me.
Yeah.
Assuming I hit you. Oh!
Ninja roll.
Yeah.
Ninja
wow. Roll. That's amazing.
So, and I would give you, like, as a free action, be like saying a call sign.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. So you say, you hear him say something that, a jumble of words that just sounds way out of context, and he just says palindrome.
Do I know what that is? Any idea? Can I make a roll to see if I.
Yeah, just luck roll.
Okay. Whether under, a single
over under,
but would Sigint help under. As well?
Yeah, sure.
45.
So under.
Saying if you want to use Sigint.
Oh.
Because that's built for that kind of stuff.
Okay, then no, I don't make it if
I
use Sigint.
Because his stats might have slightly changed.
Changed a little
because
bit
because of donation. So I don't.
I agree.
So that's why I went with luck. Yeah, you would know. You don't know exactly what it is, but it's clear that this is a communique between him and the people who are shooting at you, who are part of the same organization, which...
That was the part of this whole installation.
That links up with all your suspicions. That okay.
Got it.
And then while you are sitting with the other dude, you see him get out a syringe, and are you going to just let him...
Yeah, I'm going to try and kick it out of his hand or something.
Yeah, then that...
Ninja kick!
Unarmed, which it should say on the back. Unarmed combat, which base is 40.
And see, you went, so I still have
a
thing.
Yeah.
Well, you shot
well,
and then you met. We're
him,
at the
I
top
guess.
Of the
okay.
range
I'm
now.
To,
yeah, but I thought we cycled again.
No.
Just trying to be like
I'm the
no,
last
I'm good,
person and
like,
then it goes back to you.
Got it.
Don't need to do that. 45.
Nice.
You've been rolling pretty well.
Let me see those dice.
So that's a fail if I'm doing that, or should I base it if I'm not
traitor.
Going for damage?
Yeah, if you're not going for damage, then maybe like dex or strength?
Dex it would pass, and strength.
Okay, so you like find out, you're like, no, I'm okay, I'm okay. He's like, no, man, we need to, like, so you're able to like push him off.
Or like bop it out of his
hand. Yeah, bop it out of his hand.
Yeah,
twist
back.
It.
Yeah.
Pull it.
And then he's like, okay, we'll do this the hard way, and he pulls out a gun.
For real?
Yeah, but he...
Do you know what I've been through?
His action was trying to, like, stick you. So, what do you want to do?
Chainsaw.
God, do I even have the chainsaw anymore? I've carried it physically with me.
You could have, yeah.
It's now on your key ring.
Yeah. You had to open up your inventory.
Carabiner, right?
Carabiner. You know how one of those, you lost pieces of yourself, your hands, you now have a chainsaw hand.
Yeah.
Yeah, like on some, mm-hmm.
Yoshi bitch, let's go.
Like, I would say, like, you could, it's probably not on, but you could definitely swing it at him and hurt him.
Oh, yeah, that still
just
hurts.
Do some melee damage, okay. Yeah, I guess I'll do that.
All right.
God damn it.
Oh, shit.
Damn.
Odd five.
Okay.
Now, just to throw this out there, the garage is open, this door is open, and this back door is still open.
Yeah.
And it's going to get colder.
Yeah.
Okay. Just throwing that out there.
I mean, the hallways are and the way they're designed, it's not going to lose heat super fast, but yeah, it is getting colder.
Yeah.
You're on that side of the screen today, bud.
I know. I know. Just pointing it out. Gotta get colder.
Okay, so you definitely hit, I would say, what is unarmed for you? Is that
D4? 40% 1d4-1.
Yeah, so d4 minus 1. But this is a little harder than...
It's armed, I've got a hard thing.
Yeah, so I would say just here, like a d6.
Okay. It does the same amount of damage as it does when it's off. That's when it's on.
It does bludgeoning
four
damage.
Yeah.
Okay. It's a different kind of damage.
Yeah. Okay. So you hit him like really hard and he gives like a oof as you smack him.
Cool.
Alright.
Great.
So Mac, you're in a bird with a guy that tried to stab you and some dude just shot you.
Yeah, everything is the worst. Mm-hmm. You better help me out because otherwise we aren't flying anywhere.
I've been helping you out this whole time.
And I'm going to try and shoot him again. Maybe. Hopefully.
This is a new round, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Nice.
28.
Going to use my turn to dodge. I'm just going to have you guys focusing on me while these two trained guys roll up and take you guys out.
Yeah, but it's personal with you.
Oh, that's not good.
81.
Hey, guys, rerolls? Huh?
No!
No,
damn it.
So, you want me to roll my shotgun
damage?
You
just like the first part of the game calling them garbage people.
Of course. Yeah. They love it.
15.
Oh.
15. Yeah?
Yep.
Yeah. I'm a less...
So you get
person?
Just a chunk blown out of him.
Just more like jello?
So you fire and just... Literally just
liquefy
him, center mass, just destroy him. I'm gonna have you roll sand.
Okay.
You just killed a man in self-defense.
Yeah, and it was awesome.
Oh, there's just blood on the window. Splat.
It's very tight.
Okay, and I'm rolling against what it currently is,
yeah, what
is,
your
right?
current sand is.
Oh! No, at one.
Oh. Okay, oh, yeah.
If it's all zeros, then it's 100.
Then,
okay.
Then you're able to justify this in your mind.
Fuck that
he
guy.
He was a dick.
Yeah, I deserved it. I mean, yeah. That's fair.
So now the two guys outside are going to fire again. We'll see. That's okay, that's probably a hit. Yeah. And then a 40. So that'll be
well,
two.
Well, it's been nice, sir.
It was. Thank you, guys.
I thought she was going to be the first one to die.
Two hits.
Congratulations, you made it.
So both of you get shot at. You can use your actions to dodge if you want.
Yes.
Yeah, normally stuff like that does not happen.
No, never.
All right. Go ahead and dodge?
Yeah, go for the dodge.
No. 43.
Wait, are you trying to dodge?
Yeah.
Did you attack this turn?
Okay, yeah, yeah. So.
Oh, well, yeah. I guess I'm probably going to be murder-nated now,
yeah,
so.
You are.
But at least I took someone down with me.
Yeah. Up top.
See?
Yeah!
Are you going to die?
I'm going to unload my gun into the control panel.
Okay.
Oh, shit.
All right.
I would say,
yeah. Yeah, you can definitely, like, get that off while he's shooting at you.
Yeah.
You're going to take 9 damage from the hit.
All right.
You both will, because I rolled a... Rolled 9 for both of you.
But I want to make sure that they, like in my dying thing, I'm basically knocking out their controls and everything.
I would say that doesn't even really require a roll to like fire a couple of quick rounds into the control panel.
So, and surprisingly, you're still alive. We left you behind and you're still alive.
That's what you guys get.
Karma's a bitch.
Yeah. So I'm okay with this though.
Yeah. We deserve to die.
The guy you're with is
we're terrible people.
Mm-hmm.
We belong kind of dead.
He's trying to grapple you, so he's going to roll for a grapple, and we'll see.
Holy
if that...
Holy shit, fell into the horror movie tropes. We're the shitty ones, so we died first.
He's going to grapple at you. He grabs onto you. You can either try and fight him off with...
Wait until she comes out and finds a broken
melee,
helicopter.
Or you can,
and
strength,
I left the
or you can, like,
motorcycle,
you should turn to, like, melee
on.
At him if you want. Just
for fun. Which would potentially make him let go of me, or...?
Both would. Okay. It's just if you like, fight him off, you won't get a chance to, like, hit him back.
Okay. Did I have a chance to, like, turn the chainsaw on?
Yeah, I would say
turn?
You could, like, yeah.
Yeah,
like,
okay.
I am.
So I'm just going to swing that at him, probably in the general arm that he's grabbing me with direction.
Yeah.
29.
You've been rolling really well.
Yeah, that's a good roll. Good roll.
Very nice.
So I'm going to try and cut off his arm.
Yeah, go for it.
I'll put this on my leg.
A D10 plus 2, we'll say.
A
D10. Okay.
Oh, a D10.
I'm going to need that guy's leg.
I can't wait for this.
Five.
Yeah, you just slice off his arm, and he just starts screaming and collapsing to the ground. He's not dead, but he's definitely not going to want
it. He's on his way.
Yeah, he will die if nobody patches him up or anything. He's still technically alive, but he's sort of out of commission for now.
Now
can I just finish him?
Yeah, like, if you want to.
Finish him.
I would probably have to take a sanity check. Or
yeah,
is this like a self
pull out
defense?
His spine.
It's self defense, so it's not like the worst thing in the world.
I don't know,
but you would still have.
The homie is like immobilized. She is like, I'm gonna finish you.
Oh yeah, you're right. It would categorize under murder an enemy. So it's still you would have to. You, that is an option. I wrote down all the sanity checks.
Well, maybe I just take the syringe murder that enemy. I knocked out of his hand and use it on him instead.
Okay, if you want to do that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just stab with a blood thinner.
He just starts slowly
he'll
like gets woozy
quickly.
And passes out. But he's like he's bleeding out.
I'm gonna drag him to the basement.
Okay, I would. While
we'll work together, I will feed you, and he will help me.
If you give me milk, I'll give you this.
All right, I would say make a luck roll and tell me over or under before you roll.
Monster.
To see if I run into these motherfuckers.
Over or under.
Under.
Okay.
24.
Oh, okay,
Jesus.
You're able to actually drag him there the way. Like, you're tough. You're a tough chick. You can pull him all the way there.
I've been divorced.
Yeah. Yeah, you've been through hell. Hell and back again, and you...
The surviving action hero no one wanted.
Yeah. And then you're able to drag him downstairs and throw him into there, and you can close it and lock it if you want.
I kind of want to see what happens. Maybe just watch a little bit.
You notice, like, you throw him in there, and he's, like, he's very, like... woozy and like trying to, and then you notice the thing up top, you notice just something scoop and like just start pulling him up as he like he can't fight it off as he's being pulled to the ceiling, and then you can watch it if you want.
Fatality.
Yeah. Oh, no. You know, I got the idea.
So you
I get the gist. I'm good.
You just scream and the crunching as you close the door.
You hear a lot of screaming.
She puts on her sunglasses and
he was asleep.
Yeah.
He was asleep.
You're right. But I'm still going to make you roll a sanity check because you just fed him to a monster.
For hearing it.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
For your actions, you knew it was going to
happen. I'm just curious. I'm a scientist.
Yeah.
It was a test.
We're science.
Well, you've been pretty good at maintaining sanity, so.
Fuck you.
Wow, he just totally jinxed you right
there.
And
there it was.
That's going to be a D6.
D6, okay. 3.
Not bad.
Yeah.
So I'm at 35 sanity.
And what's your breaking point?
It's 40.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
But I was already under
it? Oh, yeah.
Okay, yeah. That already happened?
Yeah.
When does it happen again, ever?
You drop it down by, I think, another 10. So it would be the next.
30.
It would be 30.
Okay, I'm okay.
So you...
Sanity despair.
You would probably, you would lose one of your motivations, and you will gain, like, a permanent... I don't remember what the thing was, but what...
Oh, at 30, yeah.
Yeah, I don't remember what caused you to go past your breaking point, but you would probably have, like...
I think it was exploding a woman.
Yeah, exploding a woman. So you would probably have, like, PTSD from this.
Yeah.
But that
cool.
That would
permanent
be some
physical damage and mental damage.
Yeah,
I'm just so excited.
Yeah. So you threw him in there... And I'll give you another luck roll to maybe try and, like, what do you want to do now? You're alone. You just fed this man to a monster. You know that there's at least two other men out here.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of how I could trick them into going down there. And then maybe just, like, Sneaking out. Is there like any places like near the door? So maybe I could like kind of leave it open but stay hidden. And then if they came down, I could shut the door behind them and do you know what I'm saying?
I mean,
there's a few places.
Yeah, and there, and there's a trail of blood that leads down.
I'm thinking like behind the door.
I could see in the basement, leaving it open on the other side of the door, a trail of blood, and then
that's what I want
to
do.
Yeah,
and learn then, to throw your voice.
Yeah, you could just yell and say, that works too.
And then
over here,
they come in. They come in and definitely would see this trail of blood and slowly sort of investigate and like look
after murdering us.
And then like. Look through, and they don't see. They see the old bodies, but they don't see in the new bodies. But you do see them step in. So I would say you could make a dex roll to try and like get past them real quick and shut the door if you wanted to.
Yeah, I would like to do that.
Okay.
I never learned to cook.
29.
Cook. Okay. Definite pass.
Yeah,
that was on here.
So you kind of like. And when you notice them get sort of super hard, far, and you notice
super
that...
Super hard?
No, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Amazing, guys.
Fear boners.
Yeah, they love death so much. But you notice them get a little ways
fear boners.
In.
Who doesn't?
And they actually both look up, and you see that same look in your
hashtag.
Eyes that you had
hashtag
when you saw
fear
them.
Fear boners.
What the
fuck? Yeah, and so you use that moment to get in and lock the door behind them, and then you hear them screaming and pounding on the door.
But I'm cool with it.
Yeah.
I've heard that already.
Yeah.
I've been down this road
yeah,
before.
Yeah, so you've locked them in there. There's a snowmobile that could get you home if you wanted to.
Yeah.
Plenty of fuel per person.
Can I call for Caesar?
Yeah. Caesar, you head back to maybe the kennel. That's where he ran back to.
Oh, okay.
It's where he feels safe.
It's but okay,
yeah,
buddy.
You find Caesar.
Damn it, the one person
the
that we didn't want
my...
to get back.
Yeah.
I'm gonna give him the other half of my sand.
Yep. Yeah, he more than happy he hits it, eats it, and he like sort of licks at your hand and maybe your wounds a little bit because he feels bad for you because he can see that you're hurt.
Little bubby.
He's not angry. He's not fearful of her because of the infection.
No.
Oh wow.
You're totally infected.
Whatever.
No.
I'm gonna take Caesar and hop on the snowmobile.
All right. It takes you. Several hours to get there. It's not as fast as flying, but you eventually do get to the base. And when you get there, you do see Anna Fisher, the head of your facility, greeting you, and no one else. And she's like, "Is this it?"
Yeah. I mean, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, this is Caesar. Say hi, Caesar.
Hi.
This is Anna.
Hi, Caesar. I don't know. I want to say I'm sorry, but that's not. There are things in this world that I don't have to explain to you now because you know, I'm guessing.
Did you know what you were sending us into?
No. I didn't know what. I don't know now what it is, but I knew it was something, and I knew somebody had to go. And sometimes we have to send people to things where we are fairly certain people might not come back from. But I hope. Having seen what is there, you understand. I'm part of an organization that tries to that searches for things that shouldn't exist, or that people should that exist but people shouldn't know about. And the base you went in was not owned by Apache Corp is a front for a different organization that does things that messes with things people shouldn't know about. And we knew that something was up, but we didn't know what, and we had to send people. It's one of the people we sent with you was one of ours, but if we had more time, we would have sent people who were trained, but we knew we didn't have much time. But
yeah, what's the time limit then?
We knew, well, there's the storm, and we knew that they would be sending a team to clean up. They call them a blue fly team.
Well, I don't have anything to prove what happened there. You made people die for no reason. No one's gonna believe me. I look like shit.
That's kind of conducive, because we don't want people to know. We don't want anyone to know. We want to keep people in the dark from knowing the things that are out there that drive people insane to know about.
So you're gonna kill me anyway?
No, actually, if...
Am I the king?
No.
Now?
Dang it.
We have some people you might want to talk to, some therapists, but if you're if you're up to it.
Yeah, my legs hurt.
Yeah, we'll get you. We'll definitely get you.
One's
some medical
missing.
They're not.
I know. It's if, funny.
If you're up to it in the future, we might need your help for things. It's nothing. We might need you to do things, sometimes less than legal things, in order to protect the world from the kinds of things you probably have seen.
Some men in black.
Yeah. Yeah. How much does Delta it pay? Is,
yeah. It doesn't pay anything.
What the fuck?
Nobody can ever know. It's if anyone finds out in the government you're part of us, you'll probably spend the rest of your life in jail if you're not just executed.
You do it for your bombs.
Now, there's a pitch.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We don't do it for money or country. We do it because we're trying to stave off the unknown.
Well, what if I say no?
That's fine. But you're allowed to, you don't have to, like, we're not gonna, you don't have to, like, go anywhere and do anything, but you're a geologist, right?
Maybe, and a psychologist and a chemist.
Yeah, maybe someday.
Demolitions expert.
And a demolitions expert.
Maybe someday a man in a suit will say a code word to you and hand you an object and tell you to just find out what it is. Or maybe if you're working at a university, we'll ask you to make a student's project disappear off its mainframe or something like that. It's not, you may not have to ever do anything, but we might need a favor from you in the future. A favor that might risk your job, but we're hoping that you would understand it's for the good of humanity.
The greater good.
And otherwise I get nothing out of it.
No.
Do I get to know the truth?
Yeah.
The more you know about it, the worse off you are.
I'm pretty bad off.
Yeah. It gets worse.
God damn it. Well, I'll do it. I don't want anyone to end up in a position like me.
That's kind of... none of us are happy about this.
Good. We can all wallow in our big misery pool together.
Yeah. I drink.
Kind of misery
they're, still on, they're still on the tarmac, right? It's all windy and
yeah.
frozen out
and
there.
Like, all right, let's get you inside.
Let's she, have like, a scotch, Anna.
Yeah, she ushers you inside. The medical team is there to sort of patch you up, and she definitely will get you a drink.
The camera flies around and yeah. hands out.
Yeah. Cuts to inside the chamber, and they're just like nothing, and then you just see the monster, and then it just screams, and then fade to black.
Yeah.
Yes.
So guys, that was Delta Green. Woo! Thanks to the chat, that lasted a lot longer than I thought it was, because it seemed like you guys were going to run through that real quick, but then chat was like, hey, can we do this, and we do that, and then with that.
Yeah,
and
what
that.
Were the tiers? I'm curious.
The first,
yeah, what was
the
happening?
First tier was that one of you is secretly a Delta Green agent.
That was me.
Which was what?
Which is good guy, kind of?
Kind of. I was just trying to make sure no one spread whatever was going on.
The whole thing about Delta Green is they used to be a government organization.
That's why I shut the...
But then they kind of went too haywire. So now they are literally an illegal conspiracy of people who work in the government but are actively, you know, breaking the law.
They did something terrible in Cambodia.
Yeah, there
something.
Was a whole lot of like weird shit during the Vietnam War they got into. But yeah, and then the second tier was the helicopter gets sabotaged, and that went real quick. That was surprised at how fast they donated to that. Mason was a member of the
cleanup team.
Yeah, of that organization, which was just Keganis asked for it. And I figured he donated enough, he gets that. And that really helps because he put a monkey in the wrench in that. And
then otherwise, I wouldn't have betrayed you guys.
Yeah, and then the third tier, which came in just in time, was the cleanup team.
So true.
Yeah.
Because we were gone.
Yeah, we were out of there.
You were gone, and then you decided to turn back as soon as the helicopter showed up.
Yeah, because you were driving. If it was me, I probably would have kept going.
Well, I thought they were going to follow us the way that you were explaining.
I was going to have them, like, shoot out your engine at least.
Yeah, something like that. And on a snowmobile, that would have just been bad.
Yeah, because they don't have to kill you at that point. They just have to strand you in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah. So I knew that we were going to be in trouble.
I died
that.
Anyway. It doesn't matter.
Yeah,
we all did.
So.
You survived. So,
yeah.
Wow.
Suckers.
Wow. That was amazing.
Yeah, so game.
Thank
you.
Thank
you guys so much for watching and donating and helping us make this a lot of fun. I'm not sure what's next week, but I know in a couple of weeks they're doing another one of these RPG societies, and I think it's Feng Shui?
Yeah, I'm doing Feng Shui.
Yeah. Very excited.
Kung Fu Madness. in, I think that's March 6th.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It's March 6th.
That's the next one, yeah. So we'll be doing that. And then this Friday is Black Bag. And then I'm going to totally plug my Kickstarter right now for Numenera, the audio collection. We are funded. We are unlocking stretch goals, so please check it out and join us.
And stretch goals.
Stretch goals! And that's my whole thing. Anybody else? What else is going on this week?
Lost Brigade's Wednesday.
Okay.
That's right.
What's tomorrow, Dom?
Tom's running a thing, right?
Dust City Outlaws.
Yeah.
Right.
Dust City Outlaws.
That looks really good.
Yeah. And that one's also a Kickstarter right now.
Is that in Kickstarter still?
Yep.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I think they have like 10,000 or something to go. They're getting closer to their goal, though.
Yeah, that one, I really like it. It's kind of like got a leverage feel to it. Yeah. So
I'm actually not on any more of our shows this week. Phoenix Dawn Command is happening on Saturday, but I won't be there. However, Friday night, if you're local-ish to LA, Black Phoenix Alchemy Lab is having their Lunacy event, and I will be there reading tarot.
Cool.
So look that up. It's good stuff.
That is awesome. Also, in 2 weeks' time, Strategicon is coming up. We're going to be at the LAX Hilton playing games. We'll be there Friday and Saturday. Mm-hmm. I don't think we have any games set for Sunday. I know you're going to be there Friday running stuff.
I think I'm running on Sunday as well.
Are you? Okay, because I've got games on Saturday, and I know you and
Sunday
Steve
morning, yeah,
are on Friday. So come check us out. Come hang out if you guys want. Lots of slots open. You can play with us. Hang out.
Yeah, it'll be cool. Definitely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I'm not on any streams at the moment, but if you're in the Los Angeles area, you can always check me out Sunday nights at the Nerdist School Theater doing improv, or the second Saturday every month doing sketch comedy there. But that's my plug, I guess. We can where else? You can always follow me on Instagram at Mostly Shit. anyone else have any other plugs?
No, that's
like we're all beneath us.
I've been playing Res 7 over on my personal channel, Vanna_Rama. It's horrible, scary, and then. My sketch team, Dad Magic, just released a Valentine's Day music video. So if you guys want to check out that, we're on Dad Magic on YouTube, or Dad Magic Comedy on Twitter and Instagram and Facebook.
It hits too close to home.
It's too real.
Yeah,
it's too real.
Too real.
I have that horse mask. I'm like,
but
no.
Subscribe to the channel, like, watch, comment, whatever you want. Or don't. That's fine. It's also fine.
And once again, thank you to our great founder, Domwell Zocantin III, for finding this. I mean, rest in peace, Domwell. It's been so much fun following in your footsteps. Just
we'll carry on your legacy. Yeah.
To Domwell. So thank you guys. Check out, we've got shows all throughout the week. We got a bunch of stuff. Thank you to all our donators and followers. I don't know if there's anything else I'm supposed to plug.
Yes, and the moderators. Thank you guys, moderators.
Yes, thank you.
Jumping on there, adding links, whatever we need to, when you need to. You guys are the heroes that we needed.
And if you want to check out Delta Green and play it yourself, you can get, they have the quick start rules, the Delta Green need to know, which is free online.
Pay what you want, but yeah.
Yeah, pay what you want, and it's really nice. And they also have the official rule books, the Agent's Handbook, which will teach you just about everything you want to know. And they're coming out with the Case Officer's Handbook, which is basically the Dungeon Master's Guide for them. I think it's delta/green.com.
Yeah, I will say that out of all of the, they're my favorite books, and that's saying a lot because I play a lot of different role-playing games, but Delta Green is really well written. It's done really
well. Dennis Detweiler.
Yeah, he does awesome stuff.
And if you're a Patreon subscriber like me, he releases scenarios and just like little like short stories and stuff. Every month he releases a couple of things if you just subscribe to
his Patreon.
So how
much did like you write and how much was
this?
Like,
this
all
little,
of it was him.
This was all me. This was
okay,
me.
Cool,
I was like, I needed a scenario and I really love John Carpenter's The Thing. So that's what this is heavily based on, is John Carpenter's The Thing.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's great.
Well, I had fun.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
It
was great.
Nobody fell for the red herring because, like last time, as soon as someone saw the dog, they shot it immediately because they assumed it was a bad guy.
Never.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, because if you've seen the movie, you're like, it's obviously the alien, and no.
Is that it? Was just a regular.
It was just a regular dog. That's why I put it there.
Yeah. So that's why I was like, I can't do anything that I've seen in the movie. So I'm like, let's trust this dog. Let's bring it with us.
Yeah. Yep.
Turns out dogs are a woman's best friend.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Just
he abandoned me, but he came back.
He only abandoned you when a woman who he was afraid of already turned into a horrible monster.
I'm not mad at him.
An eldritch horror.
I'm not mad at him.
So
he gets a pass for running. Yeah. He's a dog.
Yeah. So thank you guys.
So cute. So cute.
Bye guys.
Thank you so much.
Bye.
Bye.